Hello, I'm Matt Leon, and welcome to week two of the University of Pennsylvania virtual football season. This week, we look back to September 24th, 2015, when the Quakers stunned Villanova on the main line 24-13.
Villanova will have Steve Weiler as the kicker doing the kickoffs, the sophomore out of Media, Pennsylvania, and Cardinal O'Hara High School. And Penn will have Eric Fiore back to return, one of their senior wide receivers up from the Lehigh Valley. And the Quakers will be in the white jerseys. And back there to return is a healthy Cam Countryman, who was out with injury last year.
Yeah. So that helps them and gives them another threat at the running back position. Steve Weiler's done a very good job on kickoffs this year. Had a handful of touchbacks, been driving the ball very well from distance.
Six touchbacks, averaging 64 on his kickoffs. We're underway into the end zone, and it will fly out of there, and Penn will get it at the 25. So we will see the Quaker offense come out. They lost to Lehigh in their first game of the season, where they scored 21 points, but they gave up 42, and they're led by an outstanding quarterback out of Huntington Beach, California, in Alec Torgerson.
Yeah, it'd be interesting to see. Penn is going to run a similar spread offense to Villanova, so a lot of that read option stuff, the bubble screens, the sweeps, it'll be interesting to see. Usually three or four wide. They're going to go five wide to start the game here with no one in the backfield.
Junior quarterback, 6'3", out of Huntington Beach, had 336 yards through the air last week in the loss at Lehigh. He threw for two scores, and he ran in a score. He's coming off a great season in which he was terrific in terms of his passing yardage, third in Penn's single season history, over 2,600 yards. He's back to pass on first and 10. He'll let it go downfield looking for his tight end, Ryan O'Malley, but he overshoots him.
Yeah, good pressure from Austin Calitro there. See, little dog in the middle, him and John Cherry kind of X-cut up through the gap, and Calitro was able to get a good hit on Torgerson. It made him release the ball a little quicker than he wanted to.
Calitro has done very well with Don Cherry, solid linebackers with Corey Majors, a couple young guys up front, certainly in Ricky Young and Eric Drains, but they've done the job, and it will be second and 10 for the Quakers from the 25. There's a chance now that Penn might slow down their offense a little bit tonight, even though they're running more of a spread. They are under first-year head coach Ray Priori, their old defensive coordinator, as Al Bagnoli is now at Columbia. It's Torgerson again. Let's it go downfield, and he's got it complete for a big gainer to midfield as he hooks up with his favorite wideout, Justin Watson.
Yeah, they went right back to the same play they ran. They liked what they saw, and this time they get the completion for a first down and puts the ball into Wildcat territory.
Had a 74-yard touchdown grab at Lehigh last week, so Torgerson and Watson like to connect as they'll go with three receivers here from midfield as a very nice play there for the Quakers on a 27-yard strike to one of their best wide receivers. The ball's at the 48-yard line on first and 10. They give it to Trey Solomon. A little bit banged up last year, but a solid running back up the middle for a few yards.
Yeah, pretty effective play on first down. He'll pick up almost a good 4 yards there to bring up second down and 6 for the Quakers.
89 yards on the ground last week at Lehigh for Solomon. That was a career high. The Wildcats will take Drains off the field along with Reggie Parrish. The Wildcats might have jumped. Could be a free play on second down, and that's no good, but penalty flags are flying there.
It's going to be pass interference and offside, so two penalties on the defense on this play. They'll decline the offsides and take the pass interference penalty, which brings the automatic first down.
Might not quite have been 15 yards there. So Malik Reeves, with too much contact, had the double-digit tackle game against Delaware last week.
Yeah, just never got himself turned around there, Nick. Never saw the ball coming. And that'll bring up first and 10 for Penn inside the Villanova 35. So it's a good first drive here for the Quakers.
Because it didn't go 15 yards. It's a spot foul. And the Quakers at the 34-yard line. Very good options to throw to. It's not just Watson. Certainly Cam Countryman. They'll use Danny Ferens and Christian Pearson, the wideout from Crespi Carmelite, California, is another good weapon there for Torgerson. It's out of the eye on the option play. Torgerson will keep it himself, and he gets a couple. It'll be second down.
Yeah, he picks up about 4 there on the read option. He decides, Torgerson decides to keep it, puts his head down, gets upfield to the 30 to bring up second down and six.
Torgerson had the second most yards of total offense in Penn single season history last year, 2,875. That was second in the Ivy League. He averaged almost 300 yards of total offense per game. A gain of four at second and six at the 30-yard line as the Quakers are driving here on their first possession.
And the Quakers are no huddle team, but they're not exactly a hurry-up team. They're going to get the reads from the sideline.
It's Torgerson on the keeper as he buries his head and gains a couple of yards.
That's going to be a first down. A nice run there. A good fake in the middle of the line. And Torgerson kept it, broke up field for a first down.
So a gain of seven, and it will be first down as Torgerson comes off the field here. And we'll see who replaces him. It's Danny Ferens taking the direct snap with Solomon to his right here on first and 10 from the 23. Their backup is listed as Andrew Lisa, but a different formation here as they'll try to give it to Solomon. Instead, the running back is right up the middle. That's the quarterback who took it himself. So Ferens on the ground there for a couple.
Yeah, Ferens listed on the sheet as a wide receiver, so you figure he's probably going to run the ball, and that's exactly what he did out of the Wildcat formation.
They like to give it to Adam Strauss in space as well, as Strauss actually ran it in for a few touchdowns last year.
Big play here for the Villanova defense. See if they can come up and force a third down here from Penn. Penn's been moving the ball pretty efficiently.
Second and seven at the 20. Sidecars there in the backfield with Trey Solomon along with Eric Fiore. They'll try to give him the ball in space as well. Out of the shotgun, they'll hand it off to Solomon. Nice room on the right side. Wildcats there to close very well thanks to Cherry along with, it looks like, Rashawn
Stewart.
Yeah,
good job by Rashawn Stewart coming up from his safety position. Put his helmet right in there at the knees. Got him down to the ground to bring up third down and about three.
A different look possibly for Ray Priori. 30th year on the Penn staff under offensive coordinator John Reagan, who comes from Kansas, where he spent a year ago in Lawrence with the Jayhawks. It's third and three at the 16-yard line. We'll work from a bit of a pistol look with Torgerson back in the game at the 16-yard line. Solomon's behind him. Now they shift the play at the line of scrimmage. They'll go with Justin Watson on the near side. They go to the left. The pitch to Trey Solomon makes one move, and he gets close to the first down
marker. I think he's got it. Yep, he looks like he got inside the 13-yard line, and he got to get to about the 14.
Corey Majors was able to get there,
yep,
a host of Wildcats, and it will be a first down for the Quakers.
Good job by Penn to execute there on third and three. The read option pitch for 4 yards and a first down.
They're getting their guys in space, and it's working so far. The center is Jack York. He's a good veteran for them. Tanner Thexton, a real solid senior as the left tackle for the Penn offense. They have a good tight end, as we talked about, in Ryan O'Malley, a senior from Summit, New Jersey. Certainly Solomon a factor. He's in the backfield. Torgerson to throw. He goes into the end zone, and it is caught for the Penn touchdown. And the Quakers strike first. It's Justin Watson who strikes for his second touchdown grab of the season.
Yeah, it looks like he beat Wes Smith on a very well-thrown ball to the corner. You know, ran it out to the flag, and he made a great catch. Great throw and catch there. And Penn strikes early and leads 6-0 with 10:48 to go here in the first quarter.
We've seen Robertson very accurate. Torgerson is very similar. He knows how to play the position, an excellent throw, and an even better catch falling out of bounds.
We saw something in their, coverage. They're playing a lot of man against us. And, I mean, Justin was a beast. And clearly, you got one-on-one with, your best receiver. You're just going to lay it up and make him make a play.
The kick will be for Jimmy Gamel, the senior out of New Albany, Ohio. Snap is good. The kick is also good. And the Quakers strike first. 7-0 Penn after one possession.
Yeah, so with 10:48 to go in the first quarter, the Wildcats will get the football, trailing the Quakers 7-0. Great drive by Penn, very efficient run and pass. Started with the pass, then ran the ball down the field very well, and then struck from the 13-yard line on the out route. A very nice pass and catch, as we mentioned, in the end zone for the touchdown.
Andy Talley, now in his 31st season as the head coach of Villanova. What do you think he's saying to his assistant coaches?
Yeah, you know, in a game like this where you're kind of you think you're the favorite in this game, you don't want it to start this way. You want to jump on a team early, try to keep them down. Penn's excited now. They feel like they're right in the game. They know they can move the ball against this Villanova defense. And it should be an interesting game now. I think it's important here for Villanova to answer with a drive. Obviously, even if they don't score, a couple of first downs, get some rhythm offensively.
Aaron Morgan handles the kickoff duties for Penn, a local product from the Haverford School and out of Bryn Mawr, Pennsylvania. And for Villanova, can special teams be a factor? We shall see with Javon White and Matt Goodzak as the main guys back to return for Villanova typically. We could see Jarrett McClinton back there to return. We'll have to keep an eye on that.
It looks like it's going to be Goodzak and Stewart back there at the 5-yard line.
It will be Stewart and Goodzak, exactly, Steve, on Penn, leading 7-0. They haven't beat Nova since 1911. Hey, you can't get off to a better start than that. Bit of a short kickoff as Stewart tried to take it as one of the up men for the Wildcats. Now the ball is loose.
And who has it?
It will be Penn football.
Yeah, miscommunication there. Stewart was going to come up and get it, and one of the up backs I couldn't see might have been 56. Apologize for not getting a good look at that. The up back was on that play.
Wildcats trying to communicate, certainly, but a special teams gaffe by Villanova, and the defense has to come right back on the field.
I think it was 85 Ryan Bell. Him and Rashawn Stewart didn't communicate on that. Both end up hitting the ball around, finds its way to the ground, and Penn jumps on it. And they have first and 10 at the 25-yard line.
Well, that's a good way to keep Villanova's typically explosive offense off the field. And Penn in the driver's seat right now.
Big challenge here for the Villanova defense.
First and 10 at the 25-yard line. It's Trey Solomon in the backfield. Torgerson will work from the shotgun with 10 left on the play clock. It's Torgerson, the California product, gets Solomon out of the backfield, and he drops it while falling out of bounds.
Really good hit by Austin Colicchio there. As it looked like he had about a 10 or 15-yard gain there as he was hitting up the sideline, and Colicchio hit him just as the ball arrived to knock it out.
Big game at Fordham 2 weeks ago for Colicchio. Had a career-high 10 tackles.
And he's been very active. We called his name twice early here.
So it's second and 10 for Penn at the 25-yard line. They'll go with three receivers to the far side. Watch out for Solomon, certainly.
I think you could see the bubble screen here maybe, Nick.
They have Watson out there along with Danny Ferens, who we've seen quite a bit, as they will hand it off to Solomon, but he is wrapped up in the backfield by Villanova. Nicely done.
Yeah, Ed Shockley, one of the reserve linebackers, in quick into the backfield, wraps him up and brings up a long third down for Penn, almost third and 15. So a big play here for the Villanova defense.
Shockley has been terrific, sophomore linebacker out of Millville, New Jersey. A lot of good depth for the Wildcat defense. It's third and 15 for the Quakers. They'll go with five wideouts and nobody back there to block, so we'll see if Torgerson gets rid of it quickly and how much pressure could Villanova send on this play with seven left on the play clock. Third down for the Quakers. It's Torgerson. And under a rush, a whistle, flag down.
We got a false start, I believe, on the left side of the offensive line for Penn.
Might have been Thexton, the left tackle, possibly Daniel Poulos, the left guard. They called on the tight end, Ryan O'Malley.
That's going to bring up third down and 20. So after the turnover, Penn going backwards right now is another, but still a big play here because, you know, if Penn can pick up maybe 10 yards, they have the ability to try a lengthy field goal here to put themselves up 10-0. So Penn actually can do well, even if they don't pick up that first down, to get himself in scoring position.
They'll call it third and 19 from the 34-yard line. And if they don't get any yardage, now it's a very tough field goal. So a sudden win possibly for the Wildcat defense, but we'll see what happens. On third down, it's Torgerson, gets rid of it over the middle, has it complete to O'Malley, and he gets a good chunk of it back.
So that's kind of what I was talking about, Nick. You pick up about 15. You get yourself in field goal range. Now you have about a 37-yard field goal attempt to go up 10-0.
It will be the first attempt. Nope, they might go for it on fourth and four. And Penn might want to call a timeout. It is for the Quakers. Right. They will talk about it. And what do you think they'll do here, Steve?
I know. They've thrown the ball in this situation the last couple times down the field. The tight end has a lot of space in the middle, or they can run that read option like they did on third and three last time. So a big stop from Villanova would be huge here to shut the Quakers out on this turnover that they picked up at the 25.
Jimmy Gamel has not attempted a field goal yet this year. He's a veteran. He's 11 for 16 in his career. But something tells us that they might try and go for it early here. Take a chance when you're the underdog.
Yeah, certainly, before that timeout, they had their offense out on the field. So the field goal unit did not come out. So the plan prior to the timeout was to go for it on fourth and four.
Coach Ray Priori spent the last 29 years on the staff, the last 16 years as defensive coordinator. Penn coming off a two-win season, their fewest wins since 1991. But they have a quarterback, and they seem to be improved. They're getting better on defense. We'll see if they can take advantage. They will be going for it on fourth and four at the 19-yard line.
Really need a pass rush here. Make him get rid of the ball quickly.
It's Torgerson in the gun. Solomon is next to him. He gets the ball. Torgerson gets it out to Solomon, but it's incomplete over his head.
There's a flag down. I think we're going to have roughing the passer here.
He got rid of it quickly. We'll take a look.
Let's hope it's offensive holding. I think it's going to be roughing the passer.
Holding on the offense. The Wildcats will decline, and Villanova's offense will see the field.
Yeah, that was a late flag. It was thrown towards Austin Calicho as he was running by the quarterback. Could have been a blow to the head, but it was offensive holding. So Villanova defense comes up big, stopping Penn, really holding them to literally just 6 yards in that drive.
So we will see Zach Bednarczyk, who gets his first career start, the lefty redshirt freshman. He is the guy while John Robertson is out with injury. 6'1", 200-pound lefty from Wallington, New Jersey. Threw for 57 yards last week in the win over Delaware. Threw for a score. He ran in that game-winning 21-yard touchdown run to put the Wildcats in front late in the ball game. He's throwing on first down from the 19-yard line, and he connects with Kevin Goulias, who's become the Wildcats' go-to receiver.
Nice pitch and catch. Good call by Sam Venuna. Something easy. Get Zach some confidence. Get him feeling comfortable. Nice pitch and catch to Goulias. Pick up 9 yards on first down. Bring up second and short.
Two touchdowns for Goulias this year, averaging 74 yards receiving through the air. He's been very solid, having to replace Poppy Livers and Mike Burke, still out with injury. On first and 10 from the 19, it will be a run right up the right side for just a couple.
That's Gary Underwood for about 3 yards and a Wildcat first down. So I think we're going to see a heavy diet of Gary Underwood tonight to take the pressure off of Zach in terms of throwing the ball. But we're going to have to make some plays in the passing game as well, but a good first down for Villanova.
So a gain of four and a first down for the Wildcats, averaging 19 points per game. They're only allowing 16 points per game, so the defense is improved. About 353 total yards of offense for the Wildcats, and they've run the ball so well typically year to year. It'll be first and 10 at the 32. Bednarczyk in the gun.
Yeah, Penn showing blitz here. See if the Wildcats can get the ball out quick.
Good transfer linebacker from Syracuse and Colton Moskal, 44 and white, and a stoppage here.
Yeah, the playcock had run down again.
Out.
I'm Justin Watson, wide receiver from the 2015 Penn football team. Thanks for watching our upset against Villanova, and please support Penn football. Go Quakers.
Let's see Villanova here at first and 10 from their own 32. See what Sam Venuto has up his sleeve here.
Gary Underwood will be in the backfield for the Wildcats. Lots of good wide receivers to throw to. Anthony DiCamillo, Taurus Phillips, good options for Villanova. 19 left on the play clock on first down for Villanova. Underwood switches over to Bednarczyk's other side. Gary gets it up the middle, no room to run, tries to bounce it to the outside, but Penn stops him.
Yeah, maybe a half a yard to a yard at all, so it's going to bring up second and long as Penn stout in the middle there, kind of blocked that all up, no room to run up the middle.
Dan Connaughton, the big nose tackle out of Lincoln, Mass. His cousin is Pat, who played hoops at Notre Dame.
Yeah, and also was a major league draft pick in baseball, so very good athletes in that family.
He's choosing to go the NBA route with the Blazers. I saw him pitch with the Irish here against Villanova baseball several years ago. Second and 9, as Underwood only got one on that last carry for Bednarczyk and Villanova. 5 wideouts. Bednarczyk to throw. He connects and's got it complete. And it's, like, it's good for Jarrett McClinton, the rookie.
Clinton with a nice little out route there, hit him for a first down. So Zach Bernard getting the ball out of his hands quickly, making the safe throws, doing a good job of being accurate, picking up another first down for Villanova.
Well, the Wildcats able to move the chains for the second time. As Bednarczyk working a lot from the shotgun, the ball's on the 42-yard line. They put a man in motion. It's McClinton. It's Underwood up the middle again, and not much running room. Now, that was Javon White.
Yeah, so they're rotating as Wildcats normally do. 2-3 running backs every game. Javon White with his first carry picks up about 2 yards to bring up second down and 8 with 6:57 to go here in the first half.
The ball's on the 44-yard line. Some backups in there, as we said, with Matt Donahue, and certainly Doug Terrell moves from tight end to left tackle. Jake Pruce had the bone marrow donation several weeks ago, and he had to play versus Delaware. Last week, the fake to Javon White. Bednarczyk going downfield. He's got Aaron Wells, but he can't hold on.
Yeah, hit him right in the hands. A great throw by Bednarczyk. And Aaron Wells just got to look that in and pull it down. I think he was running for the end zone before he had it, thinking touchdown. But that's a play you got to come down with.
They beat the freshman safety, Sam Filippi, the California native, just a step late there. You figure if they run that again, they connect with it. There's a sideline warning to Penn.
So that brings up third down and long here for Villanova.
Third and 8. We'll see how the Wildcats handle it here. As Bednarczyk once again will get his opportunity in the shotgun. Gary Underwood in the backfield for Villanova on third down. As Penn possibly showing pressure, they'll rush 3. Bednarczyk has time. It's incomplete. A catchable ball for Taurus Phillips.
Yep.
He can't bring it in.
Not an easy grab, but the ball that you want Taurus to bring in. So 2 drops, really, in that possession forces the Wildcats to punt.
Well, the good news is they've had a great punter. One of the best in the CAA is John Hinchin, the junior out of Saddle River, New Jersey, has been fabulous, averaging 46 yards per punt. And he certainly had some loud, booming kicks. We'll see how well he does here on fourth down. Penalty flag is thrown. A little bit of a wobbler, but he angles it well. It goes out of bounds. We'll check the call.
And that's John's best effort there, as you mentioned, one of the best kickers in the CAA. Kind of caught that one off the side of his foot a little bit.
Jinx. You got to stop that for
Let's see what this penalty is about. It might be illegal formation on Villanova. If it's offsides on Penn, it still brings up fourth down because it was fourth down and almost 8 yards. Looks like they're talking to the Penn sideline, so it must be against Villanova.
That'll back them up 5 yards. Penalty on the Wildcats with the illegal formation.
So Penn elects to add that on to the end of the kick. So that'll bring up first down for Penn at about the 25-yard line. Actually going to mark off the penalty, so that may take it up to the 30.
So Penn will have the football. And it will be at the 30-yard line.
Let's see if Villanova can get a 3-and-out here, Nick, and try to turn this field position a little bit.
As we said, no Matt McCann in the defensive backfield for the Wildcats. So Cam McCurry takes over as the strong safety, but he plays all over the field anyhow. First and 10 for the Quakers, leading 7-0 here midway through the first quarter. Thursday night football on the main line. First down, it's complete to the wide out Justin Watson for his second reception.
And Cameron McCurry on the coverage and the tackle there, but a nice pickup of about 8 yards for Penn here on first down. As you mentioned, they'll go no huddle, but not necessarily in a hurry.
Second and 2 on a gain of 8. A lot of shotgun for both quarterbacks early on. Just a couple of yards there
Solomon. Going to bring up third down, Nick, a little bit short of the first down. So it's going to be third down and less than 1. Penn maybe in a little bit of a hurry. You might see quarterback sneak.
Gain of 1. So third down for the Quakers. Nice job there at the point of attack for Eric Drains, the defensive tackle. Big part of that younger interior on that D line. It's Torgerson who has the pitch to Solomon, and a nice stop by Calitro.
Good job by Solomon to get himself north and south and get the shoulder pads up the field. Calitro with a good hit, but he was able to bounce off it and just get enough yards for the first down.
First down for the Quakers. They're 2 for 3 on third down so far to start this evening. Torgerson looking to the sideline for the play. Watson and O'Malley will line up on the near side. Trey Solomon, it's great for Penn that they have him healthy this year. He'll have a good season, especially in the Ivy League. That's a nice carry.
Yeah, very nice pickup again.
A gain of about 7.
Yeah, Penn really winning the battle on first down, which is bringing up second and short and third and short, making very manageable down and distance for the Quakers.
We'll call it 2nd and 4. Yes, Solomon has been very good so far. 2nd and 4 for the Quakers. Torgerson, such a solid player back there. Flag is down again. It's incomplete.
That's going to be offsides again on Villanova.
Coverage by Malik Reeves on the far side.
A couple mental errors here. Penalty starting to mount up against the Wildcats. You got to.
Offsides and the first down. That's the third penalty on the Wildcats.
Brian Osey, you know, you got to keep your eyes on that football.
They're into Villanova territory. First and 10 at the 48.
Too many mistakes here in the first quarter for Villanova.
Solid wide receivers. They can get the ball out to in space, as we've talked about with Watson and company. They take it down to 12 on the play clock. Play action. Torgerson rolling out to his left. Cherry runs him down.
There you see the speed we talked about in the pregame. The speed of Don Cherry, the ability to run sideline to sideline. He runs Torgerson down for a loss of 1.
First team All-American last year. He's the preseason CAA Defensive Player of the Year and certainly a preseason All-American as well. A loss of 1. That makes it 2nd and 11. Still in Villanova territory at the 49-yard line. Torgerson has thrown for 62 yards. He's 4 of 7 for a touchdown here in the early going. Solomon with 17 yards on the ground. Watson has 47 yards receiving. Solomon has room. There he goes. And he gets the first down on a nice darting run.
Yeah, another gash up the middle. Nice job by Solomon. He picks up 12 yards in a first down. Villanova a little bit on their heels right now. Not able to stop that run up the middle.
Solomon in a groove right now. First and 10 at the 36-yard line. And Penn will indeed try to take a little bit of time. They have the game right where they want it at the moment. And it's working quite well against the number 5 team in the country. Wildcats are 7th in the country in total defense, so they've made the stops this year. Solomon to the left. Don Cherry is there again.
Yeah, joined by a host of friends, look like Austin Calitro as well. I think Reggie Paris also went on that tackle. Gain of about 2, bring up 2nd and 7 or 8, we'll call it probably closer to 7.
I mean, getting those good chunks on first down, Steve, as we've talked about, can the Wildcats get them into 3rd and long? It's 2nd and 8 from the 34.
And it could be, you know, we're looking at 4-down territory here again as Penn opted to go for it on 4th down. At their own 24-yard line last time.
It's Brian Schanauer in the backfield, the Princeton Junction, New Jersey native. He grew up at Princeton, I guess. He played for Penn. Torgerson takes a hit, but he gets it complete to Watson over the middle. Runs away from several Wildcats before McCurry is there, and there's a fumble on the field. Penalty flags down as well. The Wildcats seem to have it, and they might get a break.
As is, flags down could be in the area of a face mask or an illegal block downfield.
It could be a post-possession foul.
I think we have 2 flags down. There's one back at the 30-yard line and then a handful at the 15, which I thought might have been a face mask on Villanova, but we'll see.
A huge game-changing play there. We'll see what the officials say as Villanova seemed to come up with it. 2:23 left here in the first quarter as Penn back into the red zone, it looked like, to set up a 1st and goal, but Watson couldn't quite hang on. O'Malley is there to try and plead his case.
I don't see.
We have a foul on both teams.
Okay.
The eligible man downfield, offense, number 76. Personal foul, face mask, defense, number 1. The penalty's offset, replay second down.
So a big play there for Penn. Yep. Offsetting fouls, it will be a redo here.
So Penn with an ineligible man downfield, and then the face mask on Villanova, so that negates the turnover that the Wildcat defense had produced. It'll bring up still second down, so replay the down. It'll be second and 8 again from the 34-yard line.
A huge break for the Quakers. Certainly they would have liked it first and goal, but I think they'll take this all in all. Torgerson, along with Schanauer in the backfield. Eric Fiore is lined up on the near side.
And Cameron Curry just giving him too much room in the slot. You know, and just too much. It's an easy pitch and catch for Watson. You know, he just slants in and they just hit him and he gets a full head of steam and off he goes.
Second and 8, just over 2 minutes left in the first quarter. Torgerson downfield looking for Watson, but he couldn't find it.
Nice job by Penn there, offensive scheme. And they'd run the slant 3 or 4 times to Watson. Now they throw the out pattern. Just an overthrown ball there. Was that Reeves back or Logan back on coverage?
Wesley Smith on the coverage. He's done a great job so far at Miramar, Florida, a sophomore. So third down for Penn. Third and 8 from the Villanova 34. The Wildcats looking like they'll play coverage here. We'll see if they send a late blitz possibly.
Yeah, Dylan Lucas getting his first appearance defensively. Looks like he might be in a blitz position.
Third and 8 is the crowd. Getting into it here, it is caught. A nice connection for a first down for the Quakers as they move the chains yet again. It's Eric Fiore on the grab.
Yeah, Penn just real efficient offensively as they beat Trey Johnson on a slant. Pick up a big first down.
A gain of about 15, first and 10. The ball spotted at the 19-yard line. Penn on the move again. Torgerson looking for a wide out. He's under pressure, and there's 10-0 Passigno.
Yeah, Torgerson probably would have been, he pumped once. He probably would have been better to get rid of that football. Passigno did a good job, stayed on his feet, maintained his position, had no passing lane at that 6-7 frame coming at him, and was able to pick up a big sack.
Now 2.5 sacks on the year for Passigno. Again, 6'7", 275 out of Ambler, PA. Has been terrific here this season. His 7th career sack to make it 2nd and 16. The ball's on the 25-yard line. With under a minute to go here in the first quarter, as Penn on top, thanks to that early touchdown pass by Torgerson to Justin Watson. 2nd and 16. It's Schanauer. He has some running room. The Wildcats make the stop, but not after a gain of about 3 or 4. Pretty nice job running the football for Penn, Steve.
Really not. He's going to pick up almost 6 or 7 there, Nick, to make it, you know, now it's 3rd and 9, and you're at 2nd and 16. 3rd and 9, it's probably 4-down territory unless they want to kick the field goal.
They'll have to run one more play as the game clock is about 3 seconds ahead of the play clock. 3rd and 9, so a crucial play to squeeze in here late in the first with 15 seconds remaining.
I think you got to watch Watson here on the near side. The guy, he has one-on-one coverage. He's been their kind of go-to guy in these situations.
3 left on the play clock. They hand it off to Schanauer right up the middle, and they get nothing. Only about a yard at most. It'll be 4th down when we come back for the second quarter here at Villanova. Penn has the lead, 7-0 against the number 4 Villanova Wildcats on Thursday Night Football here on Nova Nation All Access. We'll take a break as Penn will see if they go for the field goal when we return.
Our beloved university is facing a landscape that we've never seen before. Empty classrooms, weight rooms, dormitories, dining halls, and arenas. From Shear Pool to the Palestra, Penn Athletics is in uncharted territory. Our coaches and student athletes are navigating these challenges, but they're looking to you and to me for our leadership, our community, and our support.
In the face of monumental adversity, our student athletes have responded with resilience, positivity, and strength. The world needs courageous leaders, teammates, and champions. our student athletes are ready to take on this call. When we do return to play, we will be ready to win. It is our job to ensure our student athletes will be able to grow, compete, and win for years and years to come, be it with your volunteer leadership, as part of our mentoring and advisory network, or with your financial resources. You are needed now more than ever. The next era of Penn Athletics has arrived. With your help, we can set the future in motion.
By receiving an incredible academic and athletic experience at Penn,
I'm investing in myself and in my future.
Win the weight is about seeing adversity, not as an obstacle, but as an opportunity. I have been in awe of the support by our amazing alumni, parents, and friends during this time. In the face of our current adversity, we see an opportunity to come together as a team and a community. We will help one another maintain a clear focus on the ultimate goals and a clear purpose as we pursue excellence on and off the court. With your investment, we'll become even stronger in the future, and we'll hang even more banners in the palestra. You can set the future in motion by supporting Penn Athletics today.
Penn invests in its student athletes, in our facilities, and our support systems so that we have the resources we need to succeed beyond athletics.
We aim big to provide our student athletes with the skills to excel far beyond athletics. New voices grow and emerge through the groundbreaking work of the Penn Athletics Wharton Leadership Academy. Our advancements in mental health and sports performance empowers our student athlete excellence through a diverse set of mental and wellness services. Our priorities around inclusion and opportunity aid our commitment to helping every student athlete reach their full potential. Your support demonstrates a commitment to helping us fuel the long game.
At the core of our efforts is preparation, determination, and focus. When the campus closed in mid-March, our student athletes were able to find unique ways to train and play the sports they love while acclimating and excelling in a new learning environment. Their perseverance helped them rise to the occasion. There are no shortcuts, no sidelines, no off-season. There will be a time when we can step back on the court, and when that time comes, we will be ready.
I am grateful for the life lessons that are inherent in sport. The 2021 season will be unlike any other, and every member of the Penn Athletics community is facing unprecedented circumstances. However, the resilience that sport has taught us will help carry us through moments like these. Every day, our student athletes, coaches, and administration put in the work so that when we return to campus, we will be ready.
Momentum is something we've worked hard to build and working even harder to sustain. We simply won't relinquish the ground we've gained against our peers.
Our world is facing one of the toughest challenges of our lifetimes, and like many institutions and organizations, Penn Athletics continues to be negatively impacted. Penn Athletics will come through this stronger than ever, but we need your support. We will win the weight by continuing to invest in our programs and our 1,000 student athletes, positioning them to compete for championships while preparing them to be leaders in their communities after graduation. Help us set the future in motion by investing in Penn Athletics during these most difficult times.
And we're back here, start of the second quarter, 4th and 7 for Penn, as they'll go for the 23-yard field goal.
Actually, Nick, it's
a little bit longer.
Yeah, 33 yards. Got the 10 for the end zone. And just inside of 34 yards. So a big kick here for the Quakers. Chance to go up by 2 scores here early, first play of the second quarter.
First attempt of the year for the senior, Jimmy Gamble. 11 for 16 in his career. Christian Stapleton is the holder. Long snapper is Carson Vay, the freshman. The kick is up, and it is no good. Yeah, he missed it.
Yeah, he pulled it left, and that's another break for the Villanova defense. Two big stops in a row after the turnover. And then after Penn drives all the way down the field, is unable to convert and take a two-score lead.
Steve, tonight is our first zero-waste game. All fans in attendance encouraged to participate here at Villanova Stadium for sustainability and recycling. In partnership with the athletic department, they're aiming to divert game day waste from the trash via recycling or composting. Always fun for the garden. So very nice effort tonight.
I did see all those recyclables down in the press box, so that's a great thing. And it looks like Gary Underwood going to come out and play a little Wildcat here to start the second quarter.
We talked about it in the preview. We might see the ball in his hands. The senior out of Cincinnati will get a chance here. On first and 10 from the 20-yard line. So Bednarczyk gets a brief rest. Underwood takes it himself. We saw this a lot in the Matt Caesar days. Not a lot of running room as Austin Taps is there, the defensive end.
Gary looking for a hole there. Wasn't one to just wasn't anything there offensively. So it brings up second down and 10.
I saw number 4 running out there. Reminded me of Matt Caesar taking that Wildcat.
We'd love to see him back out there.
Doing well with the Cubs. We're about to make the playoffs, most likely. And Bednarczyk back in as quarterback on second and 9 from the 21. Javon White and Aaron Wells both line up in the backfield for Villanova. Wildcats trying to get some rhythm, certainly. It's Bednarczyk who keeps it. Nice initial stop by the Quakers. Zach makes a secondary move. Able to pick up a couple. Nice second effort.
Yeah, made a good choice here. I think he was thinking about cutting it back and going out wide. I don't think it was there. He stuck his nose in there, picked up 3 yards to bring up third down and 7.
Nice job by Jack Madden and Colton Moskal. Solid linebackers for Coach Priori's staff. Third and 7, Steve. We'll see what Bednarczyk can come up with here for Villanova. Going with 5 wide receivers. 10 left on the play clock. Wildcats trailing by 7. Bednarczyk back to pass. Decent time. It's almost picked off. Broken up by Nick Miller, the excellent freshman linebacker.
Looking for Aaron Wells over the middle. There was 3 Quakers around that ball, and Bednarczyk lucky to get away with that one.
A 3-and-out for the Wildcats. They're getting chances, decent protection. They just haven't clicked yet. The Wildcats, an important third down. They are 0-for-2 on third down. Penn is 3-for-5. So here's Hinchin. He's on the punt for the Wildcats. Very nice kick. It's a slight bobble there by Fiore, the return man. Only able to get a couple of yards there. Not much. And Penn gets it back.
Penn also, you know, kind of winning the battle of field position here as they'll start at their own 40-yard line.
Bednarczyk is 2-for-5 for 18 yards. Torgerson is 5-for-9 for 77 yards and a score.
Yeah.
Obviously, Solomon has been a key guy in the backfield for the Quakers. They'll have it first and 10 on the 40. Early part of the second quarter. Warm day here on the main line, low 80s. We'll dip down into the 70s, high 60s tonight. Little swing pass out in space is to Fiore.
A good job by Austin Calitro again. He didn't make the tackle, but forced him back inside where Sinius and Cherry were waiting to wrap him up.
Wildcats always make good adjustments as the game goes along with Coach Crocker on defense. Second and 8, a gain of 2 on that little flare out to Fiore. Torgerson again out of the shotgun. Was fantastic last year. His first main year as the starter. Up the gut for just a couple. That'll bring up another third down. Yeah.
Big down here for the Villanova defense. Third down and 6 with 12:34 to go here in the first half.
Torgerson has thrown for at least 200 yards and at least 1 touchdown in 9 straight games. He has the touchdown tonight, and he's off to a good start here this evening.
They've been pretty successful with some slant passes here in this down and distance. Let's see if they go back to the slant.
14 touchdown throws a year ago. At 260 completions last year, the second most in Penn single season history. His 26 completions per game last year led the Ivy League. A and was third in all of FCS. Third and six for Torgerson as he fires, and it is complete again.
Nice
finds
job.
Finds the tight end, Ryan Kelly.
Just, you know, an out route, 15-yard out route. Caught it right in front of Wes Smith again for the first down.
So a nice gainer for the Quakers as they're able to convert another third down. And a Villanova sideline warning. Each team has been warned one time. The Quakers are now 4 of 6 on third down.
Yeah, they've been winning the battle on third down. Very efficient Penn passing game.
They were just 3 for 10 on third down last week in the loss at Lehigh, who ran for 258 yards on the ground. Right now, Penn's defense hasn't been on the field a whole lot, and they've gotten the necessary stops early on. The Quakers have it first and 10 at the Villanova 41-yard line. Torgerson on the option. Gets the pitch there. Solomon might have had a bobble, but is able to hang on, and he's met by a number of Wildcats in the backfield.
Nice job by Rob Roll coming out his safety position. Good job by Cherry to Kalitra to force the pitch, and then Rob Roll was there to finish off the running back.
How about Dylan Lucas coming off the injury from last year? They might not have expected him back. He's out there. What a tough guy.
No doubt about it.
Second and 11. They lost yardage on that one. The Wildcats starting to swarm to the football quite well. They'll have Countryman along with Ferens and the tight end Ryan O'Malley out there on the far side with the running back Schanauer and Watson on the near side. Five wideouts for the Quakers on second and 11. Torgerson up the middle, but Kalitro is there to stop him.
Nice job by Austin Kalitro. He's been very active here in the first half. Actually went for the strip of the football and almost got it out there. Would have been a big turnover for Villanova.
Wildcat linebacker is always reading that play so well.
Here comes another third down, Nick. Third and about 13. See if Villanova can get off the field here.
Third and 13. The Wildcat defense is sending Penn backwards on this drive.
Looks like the Wildcats may come blitz here, man-to-man outside.
Showing some pressure at the line with Cherry and possibly Lucas, maybe Kalitro. Third and 13 for the Quakers. Here comes the pressure, and down he goes! Tano Passigno for the Wildcats, his second sack tonight.
And a big loss of yardage there as they just sent the jailbreak. It was seven guys, five guys can't block seven. Passigno gets in there and picks up his second sack.
At some point, you make adjustments. Instead of giving Torgerson time to throw, they put the pressure on.
Yeah, good call by defensive coordinator Billy Crocker to mix it up a little bit. Torgerson nowhere to go with that football as he was swarmed under by the Villanova defense.
Penn has had the ball for 12 minutes time of possession-wise. The Wildcat offense, barely 4 minutes they've been on the field.
Looks like the Wildcats are going to be offsides, I believe, yep.
Another penalty flag. They run into the kicker as well.
So that's going to be a first down. I think that's going to be a personal
foul.
By Hunter
Kelly.
That's going to be a personal foul, I believe, in roughing the kicker. So that's going to give, if it's a personal foul, that's 15 yards and an automatic first down.
We'll check the call as the Wildcats will be flagged yet again. Multiple fouls. And another break for the Quakers. They'll stay on the field.
Just think of some of the mistakes that Villanova's made in this first half. The fumbled kickoff, the two drop passes on the first drive, the penalties here, giving the ball back to Penn in Villanova territory with a personal foul roughing the kicker penalty.
Thursday night games are not easy on anybody. The preparation, it's a short week. It sometimes they're not the prettiest of football games. Right now the Wildcats struggle a little bit.
You really need to maintain your mental focus in these types of games. We've had a lot of mental mistakes here. It's fourth down and 14. You can't commit a personal foul in that situation.
First and 10 from the 36 for Penn's offense. They continue to dominate time of possession and third downs.
And how many times can you ask the Villanova defense to step up and get a stop? And
they've made several good stops as of late. They get the handoff here to Schanauer, who gets about four. Nice job in coverage there by Rahsaan Stewart to come up and get him.
Going to give him about three, it looks like. So it'll be second down and seven.
Penn threw it 19 more times than they ran it last week at Lehigh. They had to play catch-up most of the game. Different scenario tonight where they're in control, they have the lead, and they've been able to have a good balance of running and passing. 16 runs, 10 throwing attempts for Torgerson. Gets it complete to Justin Watson. He shakes one tackle. He shakes a second. There goes Watson, and he's in for the touchdown.
Yeah, just really poor tackling by Villanova in his secondary. As he breaks two tackles, the first, I believe, was on Cameron McCurry. I didn't see who the second man was, but just really sloppy play from Villanova in the defensive backfield.
Second touchdown tonight for Justin Watson. He has been tremendous this season. That's three touchdowns on the season. Had 10 catches for 143 last week at Lehigh. And Penn is about to go up by two scores.
Yeah, you got to wrap up there. And just get him to the ground, and McCurry was unable to, and then he broke another tackle in the secondary to waltz into the end zone.
Gamble is on for the extra point. It's up, and it is good. With 7:53 left in the second quarter, it's Penn 14 and Villanova nothing.
Going up two scores against the number 14 in the nation at the time, like you're feeling good, you're feeling confident, but you're not getting overconfident because you know there's still a second half of football to play.
Well, certainly a very tough start for the Wildcats. A combination of mistakes. There's some poor tackling normally.
Yeah, but
McCurry makes that stop.
Yeah, and you go back to the roughing the kicker penalty. Villanova's got a stop, got off the field, and you give Penn the ball back with a short field, and they're able to convert. You just can't leave your defense out there the whole day. And unfortunately, the sloppy tackling leads to a second score for Penn.
So a nice job in space there by Watson. And Penn graduated two pretty good workman-like wide receivers in Connor Scott and Spencer Kulsar. Two really solid all-Ivy League picks last year, as Kulsar had close to 1,000 yards receiving last year. Torgerson has certainly transformed this program. They have a solid quarterback. And right now, Penn's making the plays.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Villanova's going to maybe need a big play here in special teams. Just something to energize this crowd and this offense today. We get them going a little bit. Just been very, very unemotional game from the Wildcats up to this point.
A 33-yard touchdown run and score there by Watson. Torgerson has thrown for a couple of touchdowns, both to Watson, who has 80 yards receiving. The kickoff, another short one from Aaron Morgan. The Wildcats able to field this one cleanly on the fair catch by Padovani, it looks like.
So an effective play there by Penn. Villanova will take over the 20. If they kick off and just kick the ball in the end zone, you get it to 25. So nice job by the special teams from Penn.
Not letting Villanova get a big return, trying to take special teams out of the equation. A smart move by the Quakers. And we'll see how Villanova continues to roll here on offense. Jake Pruce, the right tackle tonight, we mentioned, having the bone marrow procedure. So a man here in Philadelphia had to come in last week when Brad Seaton and Greenridge, the freshman tackle who had been playing well, he got hurt. And a nice run by Jarrett McClinton on the jet sweep.
I think we're going to have holding on Villanova. It looked like Jake Pruce on the edge. He's going to bring this back. Yeah, it is Jake Pruce.
Another penalty on the Wildcats.
And he was actually behind the play, so it really had no effect on the run, but unfortunately it's going to bring up first and 20.
Fifth penalty for the Wildcats. 45 yards of penalties. Backup offensive line. Kyle Wallace, kind of a late change.
Yeah, unfortunately Kyle had a death in the family. He's not here tonight.
Right now the center is Jonathan Green, a very experienced lineman. He's played mostly guard over his career. But Pruce is out there as well. Solid option for the Wildcats. Matt Donahue's playing at right guard. It's a different looking offensive line, a big factor. First and 20 for Bednarczyk in his first career start as a Wildcat for the redshirt freshman lefty. He's back to throw here. Great footwork we've seen. It's tipped, and it's incomplete.
Yeah, looking for Padovani outside. Just couldn't get it up over the defensive back. Nice job by the Penn defense there. Spadovani had a step on his man.
Jack Madden, the linebacker there to break it up.
Yeah, Bednarczyk just not quite able to get it over to the linebacker and drop it in front of the safety.
Zach is now 2 of 6 for 18 yards. Wildcats at times giving him some time to throw. Penn has either been able to get their hands on the football. The Wildcats have had some drops on that long play. Just not real crisp, Steve.
No, not at all.
It's 2nd and 20 for the Wildcats. Let's see if they get it going. Bednarczyk will throw on the run. It's complete out there along the far sideline to Taurus Phillips.
I think we're going to have a late hit. Yeah, I think we're going to have a late hit, which really Villanova needed some help there because he actually stepped out at about the 14. Looks like we're going to have a late hit out of bounds for an additional 15 yards.
Lots of penalty flags. I think the last time we were together, Morgan State last year, there were a lot of penalties in that one.
It seemed that way. And finally one going against Penn here as Villanova has been the culprit most of the time here in the first half.
I hope we're not the unlucky factors.
I don't like the fact that these referees are kind of huddling this long to see if they're going to pick up the flag or not. Shouldn't take this long to discuss.
Penn trying to plead on their sideline about the call. It'll be third down for the Wildcats. They pick up the penalty flag. Not a break for the Wildcats.
Now, someone thought Villanova would have a first and 10 at the 30-yard line. Now it's going to bring up 3rd and 15. So, obviously, a huge pickup of the flag there against Villanova.
So, we'll see what the Wildcats can come up with here. Goulias lines up on the far side. 3 to the near side. Wells in the near side slot. Looks like they'll go Bednarczyk shotgun. Here on 3rd down, Underwood in the backfield. Bednarczyk under pressure, has to get rid of it, and it's incomplete. The pressure was there in the backfield, and Villanova will have to punt.
That's just a really tough play. He's rolling right and throwing all the way across his body to the left sideline.
Penn gets the stop, penalty flag. Tyler Drake, an outstanding linebacker, really puts pressure on the quarterback, an outstanding pass rusher. And he was able to get in the backfield there. And the Wildcats will punt from the 1-yard line. The field position battle has certainly been won by the Quakers. As Hinchin gets a very nice kickoff, fair catch signal by Fiore. And Penn will get it. With 6:45 left before halftime.
A 47-yard punt from John Hinchin there. Really, Wildcats really needed that one. Now with 6:45, it's up to the defense to get a stop and try to get the ball back to the Villanova offense so they can get something before the half.
Can the defense make a play to get a turnover, to find some sort of rhythm? A team that was picked first in the preseason Colonial poll. But these rivalry games are always quite tricky. And you know, Penn is hungry for a victory against the Wildcats. They have not beat Villanova since 1911. 1st and 10 for the Quakers at the 39-yard line. It's Trey Solomon who gets that initial burst to get about 6.
Yeah, almost 7 yards. Just Villanova's just not doing a good job tackling tonight. You know, it's that short week you talk about. You don't have a lot of days in pads, but Villanova not doing a good job of wrapping up.
Of course, this game was moved up to Thursday night because of the arrival of Pope Francis here into the Philadelphia area coming up this weekend. He's made his way to New York today after being in Washington, D.C. the last day or so. It'll be 2nd and 3 for the Quakers. A nice gain for Solomon. Torgerson, that's a low throw. Incomplete, intended for Watson.
Yeah, just not a good throw there from Torgerson. It's kind of the first ball that's gotten away from him all half. Now it brings up 3rd down for Penn as the Wildcats really need a stop here.
A key 3rd down. The Wildcats are 0 for 3 on 3rd down on offense. Penn is 4 for 7 on 3rd down. It's been a key factor here this evening.
Let's see if Billy Crocker dials up the blitz that was very effective in the last series.
Wildcats trying to get in position. They snap it quickly. Torgerson gets it out, looking for Watson, and he gets the 1st down.
Good job by Penn. They knew it was coming there, so it was a quick one-step drop. Get it out of your hands, because they knew the Penn that Villanova was going to all-out blitz him. They pick up the first down.
How about Justin Watson? He's had a great start to this season. First down for the Quakers. Another third down conversion for the Quakers. That's 5 of 8. They'll get it first and 10 at the 47-yard line as they are into Nova territory again. The Wildcats don't lose at home very much. They are 30-10 here at home since 2008. Torkerson to throw again, and a bullet that is incomplete.
Yeah, Corey Majors did a good job of getting in the lane there, the passing, then got a hand up and really just disrupted that whole play.
Nice job there, as you said, to kind of screen the receiver, maybe throw off his line of sight. Watch out for Watson on that far side. O'Malley is tight to the right. Their talented tight end on 2nd and 10 from the 47. They really like O'Malley, who was all conference last year. It's Torgerson up the middle. He gets a couple. It'll be another third down.
That dreaded third down here. See, Villanova one more time can try to get off the field at 3rd and 8. 5:15 left here in the second quarter. So you'd like to give the ball back to your offense with an opportunity to do something before the half, as Villanova will receive the second half kickoff.
3rd and 8 for the Quakers. The Wildcat defense trying to come up with a stop here. They could certainly use one. They check the defense from the sideline. 11 left on the play clock for the Quakers. 2 timeouts left apiece with under 5 to let play here in the second quarter. Torgerson, Wildcats bringing the blitz. It's caught by Ferens underneath, and it's another first down for the Quakers. Yeah,
Torgerson just picking apart the Villanova defense. Penn doing a great job of mixing up run and pass, going left side, right side. Really good job by the Penn offense.
Torgerson threw for 300 yards or more 4 times last year. 61 attempts throwing the ball last year against Princeton set a school record. And he set the school record for completions in a game 2 different times last year, 40 completions in 2 separate contests a season ago.
He's just been very accurate all day.
Here's the pitch to Solomon. Calitro on the initial contact with help from Brian White, the freshman. He's done really well as a D lineman this year. Local product out of Westchester.
Yeah, his father Ted was a player here in the 80s, and his brother TJ, a backup linebacker on the roster as well.
Penn continuing to move the football. They'll say 2nd and 6 at the 31-yard line. Low snap. Torgerson picks it up and hands it to Solomon, but no running room there thanks to the Wildcat defense. Tano Passigno and Reggie Paris, it looks like. That was Eric Drains who got him that time.
That brings up about 3rd and about 4 here from the 29. I think Penn was just 2-down territory for Penn, so would not be surprised if they ran the ball here.
3rd and 4 for the Quakers with 3:18 left in the second quarter, leading 14-0 over the Wildcats. Torgerson has thrown for 144 and 2 scores. On 3rd down, they'll run the option play. Torgerson takes off, and he gets the first down.
Good job on the read option there. He saw that he had a lane. Instead of pitching, he kept it, turned it upfield, got himself a first down.
Well, certainly the Californians doing the job for Penn tonight. They have 20 Golden State natives on this roster, and Torgerson has been certainly quite the factor in this one. Another conversion for the Quakers on 3rd down. 7 of 10 overall tonight on 3rd down. 1st and 10 at the 22. Torgerson again. There's the pitch. It's to Schanauer. Makes a move. Majors was there.
Picks
along
up
with
about,
Rob Roll.
Yeah, pick up about 3, so bring up 2nd down and 7 inside the 20 here with almost getting down to about 2 minutes left here in the first half. So Penn doing a great job of time of possession, as we talked about earlier, Nick. And even here, if they don't score, they've basically taken up almost the whole half for Villanova not to have an opportunity to get the ball back.
2 minutes left before halftime on 2nd and 7 for the Quakers. From from the Villanova field, takes the initial hit, and then they drive him back. The ball is loose. What's the call?
I think they're going to call him down by contact at the 15-yard line.
McCurry came up with the loose ball, but it did appear that Torgerson was indeed down.
I think it's gotten too deep now, but I thought Villanova could have used some timeouts on defense here. It brings up third down. Penn now just going to run the clock down.
Gain of four. Third down. Third and three for the Quakers. Penn seven of ten on third down, Steve.
Yeah, Penn smartly in no hurry here. They have 15 still on the play clock. Don't leave Villanova any time to score on offense.
Into the final minute here of the first half. It's up the middle with Schanauer.
It looks like he's going to be about a half yard short of the first down. So it'll be an interesting decision here from the Penn coaching staff. It brings up fourth down. It looks like they're going to go for it.
Nice job by McCurry to come up and make that snap and that tackle. Penn has two timeouts left. 39 seconds left before halftime. It'll be fourth and one for the Quakers. And penalty flags
I think
come
up. The Villanova defensive line looked like they jumped. Well, let's see if they were drawn offsides. I thought Villanova moved into the neutral zone first.
Penn was 0 for 3 on fourth down last week. 5-yard offsides against Villanova. First down for Penn.
That's going to bring up a first down and goal for the Quakers with 32 seconds left here in the half.
Boy, a lot different than last year when the Wildcats ran away in the first half and the year before, frankly. This is more like the 2000s decade when the games were close year to year. First and goal from the 8 for the Quakers.
Now Villanova decides to take a timeout here to kind of regroup defensively. This is
last week at Lehigh. And tonight they are 1-for-3 on scoring plays. Torgerson has thrown for a couple touchdowns. Penn has run for 72 yards on the ground. The Wildcats have run for 10 yards on offense. They barely had the football.
Yeah, it's really been all one-sided. And, you know, you almost have to feel, if Villanova can get out of here at 14-0, you have to feel almost lucky that it's only a two-score game.
Penn has run 44 plays. The Wildcats have run just 13.
Yeah, you know, what you thought was the strength of this team, the Villanova defense tonight, has just been unable to get off the field. And then obviously I keep going back to, but that roughing the kicker penalty that gave Penn another possession and a short field that they cashed in for their second score.
They've done quite well this season defensively. There's no doubt about it. They'll say first and goal at the 8 for Torgerson. And the Quakers on first down. The Huntington Beach, California native under a rush, and he's down. Nice job to grab him in the backfield there for the Wildcats.
Yeah, Brian Osi got him coming around the right end. Penn takes a timeout with 24 seconds left here in the first half. That'll leave the Quakers with one timeout.
Smart timeout there. As Osei, the Temple transfer, a lot of speed off that edge. Another nice addition to this Wildcat defense.
So a loss of about 4, so that brings up second and goal from the 12.
Chances are now with no timeouts left.
Actually, Penn, I believe, has one left, Nick.
They do have one left. So they still can run the football, but chances are with little time left, they still might attack through the air. Wildcat defense certainly talking it over. Scoreboard now saying each team does have one timeout.
Now, obviously, I don't know the confidence level of the Penn kicking game. They've missed one early, but a field goal here still makes it a 3-score game going into halftime.
No doubt Torgerson has come up with big plays here tonight. I'll say second and goal from the 12. O'Malley, the tight end, is tight left. It's Schanauer in the backfield. Three wideouts for Penn here on second and goal. It's Schanauer off of left guard, and he gets a few yards. And there's that timeout. Yeah,
now Penn forced to throw the ball here, Nick, with 17 seconds left on third down.
Final timeout for the Quakers. As they'll have a third and goal coming up here. Well, they'll get to throw it at least once, and you figure they want to take a shot at the end zone to make sure they have enough time for a field
goal. And now if you're Penn in this situation, you can't take a sack. And obviously, if you do throw the ball in the field of play, you either have to throw it into the end zone or you have to get out of bounds because it's going to be fourth down. They're going to have to run their field goal unit on or try to line up and get a quick playoff, which I guess it's going to be very difficult with only 17 seconds left.
And we have seen a lot of penalties tonight. Just keeping that in mind, you have to be careful if you're an offense. It's a 10-second runoff if the offense commits a penalty in the final minute of a half. So Penn certainly has to be very organized. We've seen a lot of players jumping around, some miscues tonight. Penn has been rather solid, however. They have controlled this first half.
And then down here, I always look for those big bodies. Usually your tight ends in the red zone. Maybe O'Malley here for Penn, be someone to watch out. 85 out in the slot on the right-hand side of the field.
Certainly a very key contributor on the All-Ivy League selection from a year ago.
And Watson's down on the short side of the field one-on-one as well. Those are probably the two men they're looking to here.
It might be man coverage for Watson on that near side. On third and goal from the 7 for Torgerson. He's going for Watson again, and he has it picked off. It's picked off by Villanova, and it's run back by Malik Reeves. Malik Reeves is still on his feet. Malik Reeves is out of bounds with 5 seconds left.
And a late hit, that's going to boom him 15 more yards, and it could put Villanova in field goal range.
Yeah, I mean, we were never wavered within our confidence. We knew what we were capable of doing, and, you know, we failed to convert on that fourth down and, you know, capitalize on a prime opportunity to go up 2 scores in the first 2 drives. And, you know, we were fortunate enough to still, you know, have a good enough defense to where they were holding them to, you know, 3 and outs and very short drives where they weren't getting any points or capitalizing on anything. So
that interception or fumble recovery, whatever you want to call it, they almost took that back to the house. So the fact that, you know, our linemen and players were hustling back down the field to make sure that that he didn't score was kind of a good shift for us.
If there's a game-changing play at the end of a half to get you going into the locker room, that might be it.
I thought there for a second that he might go all the way. It looked like he had a lane, but Penn did a good job of converging. He was stuck on that sideline. And let's see the flag, because that's a late hit. That's an extra 15. That moves it down to the 20. And then Coach Talley has a decision.
One timeout left.
But only 5 seconds. You're probably only able to run one play.
They're calling a 5-yard sideline interference call on the Wildcats.
I got to be honest with you, Nick. I've been to a lot of Villanova football games over the last year. I've never seen that one. Never seen that call before.
I swear, in football, every week you see something new.
You really do. So this sets the Wildcats up for a chance for a Hail Mary here from the 39-yard line. You know, go 3 guys wide and chuck it up and hopefully you catch one.
Too long at this point for either Weiler or Gerard Smith, who might get a chance to kick tonight. There's John Robertson giving his wisdom to the team while he's out with injury.
Now the key here is you just need your O-line to hold up long enough to get your receivers down into the end zone and you go try to get a jump ball.
BYU has done it twice this year. It'll be at the 39-yard line with 5 seconds left. One timeout left for Villanova just in case. Bednarczyk will get a chance here. He's under pressure and he fumbles it and the Wildcats can't even get it off. Ball's still loose, now it's down, and the half is over.
Yeah, that's what I tell you. You need your O-line to hold up there so they can get the guys down to the end zone. You know, you got to run 40 yards. It takes a speedster 4.4 to get down there.
An upset brewing possibly here at Villanova Stadium. Our score at halftime, it's Penn 14 and Villanova nothing. You're watching Wildcat football on Nova Nation All Access.
To help us remember this game, we are joined by several key players who were a part of it. Defensive lineman Tyler Drake, defensive lineman Dan Connaughton, quarterback Alec Torgerson, and linebacker Don Panciello. Guys, thanks for joining us. Villanova had handed it to you guys the last couple times you had played them. What is your thought process? Short week, it's a Thursday night going into this game.
We had never played a Thursday night game. We were ready to attack it.
The short week's probably a good thing in that instance, because we did not, I don't think anybody thought we played well at Lehigh.
I was in a walking booth that entire week, so I didn't really practice that week.
What do you remember about the defensive game plan, what you guys wanted to do heading into this one?
we kind of wanted to go back to basics, kind of go out in base, see what they're coming out in, and go back to fundamentals. It was easy for us in the first half. I think we actually only played two or three defensive drives the entire first half. Offense was killing it, converting on third down, long drives.
Did you guys want the ball first purposely, or am I making too much of it?
John Reagan, the offensive coordinator, he wanted the ball and wanted to score.
The whole game plan going in was really just ball control and, you know, these long sustained drives and just keeping their athletes off the field.
The other 3 years that I had played Villanova, it had kind of gone the opposite way. Like it was usually them scoring first, us going three and out, and then, you know, the floodgates would kind of open. So when you have an opportunity and you're playing a big team like that and you go down the field and do something as dominant as we did, just completely controlling the football, converting and then scoring, I think they were a little shocked that we did that to them. So, and it was also a huge confidence boost for our sideline, just us knowing like, okay, we can play with these boys. Let's get after it.
Do you start to sense in that first half some frustration from them, just in the maybe the body language or what you're hearing between plays and stuff?
When we come out, drive the field, score on the first opening drive, and they come out and kind of, you know, can't connect on anything. On offense, they were kind of, you know, looking around, a little shell-shocked. And I think them not establishing long drives or converting on anything definitely messed with their confidence a little bit, especially in the first half.
You know, their defense was just tired. You could sense it in them. They were just tired. They had been, you know, we run like 50 plays in the first half. You know, your D-line can't get up the field on a rush anymore. So, you know, you could sense their confidence starting to waver a little bit. That locker room at the half was, you know, something special to be a part of. It was a lot of energy and it was a lot of fun.
We had a feeling that it was going to be a dogfight in the second half. We knew that, you know, their coach was, we're going to get their players ready to go at halftime and come out and do something different.
Coach Benson's mantra didn't really change. It didn't waver. It was tackle, create turnovers, and get the ball back and control the game. The mantra was keep going. Don't change anything.
You know, we had to get prepared for the second half, and they came at us with a bunch of weapons. They had to pass a lot in the second half. So we were in some diamond nickel packages, just kind of, you know, corral them and play everything deep to short and kind of, you know, control their athletes that way.
I think like these guys said, you expect it to be a dogfight and you expect their best shot coming out of halftime. And luckily for us, we hadn't been on the field a ton the first half. So you got some serious energy, but excited to get back out there for sure. We felt like we hadn't really played much, right? Which we hadn't in the first half. So jacked up to get back out there.
It was a little surreal, honestly. Like we were up, you know, three scores in the, you know, late in the third. So it was like nervous excitement energy.
Excitement and a little bit of shock, you know, a team that some of the greatest teams that have been at Penn, you know, never did what we did. You know, to do it with a group that was already so close knit, you know what I mean? And coming off two, you know, not great seasons. It was special. And I was glad I was able to share it with those guys.
Set the table for, you know, what we did the rest of the season. It was exactly what we needed. It was we put all three phases of football together, offense, special teams, and defense. And, you know, it really showed that, you know, sky's the limit. Like we're playing with the best and, you know, a top five team in the country.
And it was like everything fell into place. The Pope was in town. It was a weird Thursday night game. They were ranked. We were coming off a tough loss. Offense ate the clock all game. We played pretty good on defense. And then Donnie ran that kickback and we started celebrating. And we had three nights to celebrate afterwards. So it was good. It was perfect, man.
And here's the opening kickoff of the second half. It's Aaron Morgan on another short one. It's Cam McCurry who takes it. And the Wildcats have the ball first to start the third quarter, trailing by a couple of touchdowns.
Yeah, not quite as effective with the short kick there. The Wildcats got pretty good field position outside their own 35-yard line. So it'll be first and 10 at about the 36. Wildcats obviously need to pick it up here. Let's see if they can put a drive together, make some adjustments at the half, and see if Zach Bednarczyk can get them going here offensively.
Seven penalties against the Wildcats in that first half. Only one for Penn, who dominated time of possession. 24 minutes to just 5.5 minutes for the Wildcats. 48 plays for Penn in that first half, just 14 for Nova, as they try Javon White on first down as the running back for the Wildcats gains a few.
Yeah, he picks up about 3 yards on first down.
Javon White, really solid at Fordham, a career-high 123 yards rushing 2 weeks ago in the win in the Bronx. He had a 34-yard and a 24-yard run that night. He's ninth in the Colonial in rushing yards entering this week. Second and 7 for the Wildcats as Zach Bednarczyk, so far in the evening, has thrown for just 23 yards. Play action, Bednarczyk, throw is low, and it's incomplete.
Yeah, Zach inaccurate there. Had Goulias on a little out pattern for a first down, just short hopped him with the throw. Career, so big third down here to start the second half for the Wildcats.
Career high 8 catches last week for Kevin Goulias. It was 152 yards receiving, of course, on the first play from scrimmage, that big 70-yard bomb from John Robertson. So it's Zach Bednarczyk, the redshirt freshman lefty for the Wildcats, only the second ever lefty quarterback to play under Andy Talley. The other was former walk-on Christian Colasurto from a few seasons ago. Third and 7 for the Wildcats, but Narzik will take it himself and only gets about 3. Penn makes another stop. It's been a battle of third down. The Wildcats are 0 for 4, Steve.
Yeah, you know, the Penn all-out blitz there. Bednarczyk tried to beat it, and it was kind of a run blitz. If he was able to elude that first tackle, had some open field, but a good job of tackling by the Penn defense.
So it'll be Hinchin to punt for Villanova. You think you get the ball out of the locker room, you go on a long drive. Instead, the Wildcat defense, barring a mistake here or a fake, back on the field again. Fair catch signal for Fiore. Pretty decent punt indeed by Hinchin. And Penn's offense is led by Alec Torgerson, 144 yards through the air. He's thrown for 2 touchdowns, both to Justin Watson, Steve. They've been effective on the ground as well.
They've been very efficient offensively. And what they've done, too, is just we talked about, just control time of possession. Forced the Villanova defense to be out on the field. Their conversion percentage on third down extremely high. Villanova here is going to have to try to get off the field and give their offense more opportunities.
And we'll see how well the Wildcat defense does here as Penn has it first and 10 from their own 14. A real solid kick there by John Hinchin. They'll give it to Trey Solomon, a little burst from the left side. He gets a few.
You know, he's going to pick up about 4 yards there on first down and bring up second down and 6 from the Quakers.
Solomon had 46 yards in that first half. As Penn, pretty solid on the ground. All in all, they ran for 75 yards. The Wildcats ran for just 6 yards in that first half. Tano Passigno up on the line. Don Cherry calls out the signal. Malik Reeves had that big interception, his first of the season. To end that first half, there's Torgerson under a rush, gets it out in space to O'Malley, who's taken down on a nice hit there by Wes Smith.
Good job by Wes Smith. Went low at the big fella, got him down on the ground. Good rush from McCurry, forced Torgerson to get rid of the ball before he wanted to. For no gain, picks up about maybe a half a yard. It's going to be third down and about 5.
Another crucial third down. The Wildcats trailing 14 to nothing early in this third quarter. They have to make a play to turn this game around. They blitzed a few times tonight. We'll see if they play coverage against another heavy wide receiver look for the Quakers on 3rd and 4. Torgerson, the slant pattern. Calitro has the coverage. It's incomplete, and the Wildcats get that much-needed stop.
That's a great job by Calitro. As he came off the tight end and went into the flat and picked up Ferentz right there in the flat, and a good job of getting a hand in there to deflect that ball out of the hands of Ferentz. So a great job by the Villanova defense to get the ball back to the offense. Let's see if McClinton maybe can break something here in the punt game.
Hunter Kelly on the punt, 6'1" sophomore out of Huntington Beach, same hometown as Torgerson, averaging about 31 yards per punt, as long as 44 this year. He gets it away. A little bit of a wobbler. McClinton backs up the rookie slot. He fumbles it, picks it up, makes a pretty decent return of it all in all, as he gets about 8 or so on that return after the initial muff.
So with the exchange of punts, the Wildcats pick up about 7-8 yards. And let's see if they can get something going here, Nick. Just need a couple of positive plays here to get the ball into Penn territory and get themselves on the scoreboard.
You're trying to figure out, is it the running game against with an offensive line that's a little bit new, guys in different spots, you're without some key veterans because of injury. Obviously, you're down your historic record-setting quarterback.
Yeah, I think you're going to have to throw the ball a little bit on first down because you rush for 6 yards the whole first half, and you can't kind of get yourself into second and 8, third and 6. Those opportunities have not panned out for the Villanova offense. So I like throwing the ball a little bit on first down to loosen up this defense.
First and 10 from the 43 for Bednarczyk, the redshirt freshman, and the Wildcats. Well, fake it to Underwood. Bednarczyk, no time to throw, and he goes down.
Yeah, the Villanova interior, that offensive line has been manhandled by the Penn front for the most of this game.
Connaughton.
And right there, yeah, Bednarczyk had nowhere to go with that football. And a loss of about 8 on the play.
Looked like Tyler Drake got in there as well. Outstanding outside rushing linebacker. Fantastic player. All Ivy League honorable mention last year. 6 sacks, which were second best in the Ivy League. They love to shoot him off the edge. And what's a bit of a 3-4 look, but they have those linebackers play close to the line of scrimmage quite a bit. Nice job for Bob Benson. Spent last year at Albany. Really improved that defense up there for the Great Danes. On 2nd and 17, Bednarczyk on the play fake. Throws off balance, and it's picked off. It's intercepted by the Quakers. Nice job there to grab it in space by Sam Filippi, the freshman, and the Quakers.
There is a flag down, Nick. There's 2 flags down on the field. I think it's going to be offensive holding against Villanova, which would bring this back. But there is a flag also at the 40 that could go against the Quakers, offsetting penalties. We replay the down.
Quakers might get it. We'll check on
I
what
see now Villanova's offense
of
coming off the field.
And they'll say it's holding on Villanova, and it will be Penn's football, as now we're into the turnover game. Penn turned it over late on that interception by Malik Reeves, and now Bednarczyk throws his first career
pick. Yeah, just the offensive line has not been able to hold up on that drive. He was forced to get rid of that quick. Probably a ball he wants back, but he sees Goulias down the middle of the field, tries to get the ball to him and had to release it before he wanted to, come up short with the throw.
And that means Penn can go back to work on the ground.
Well, he's been the one defender. We've called his name a lot tonight. That seems to be having a heck of a ball game, Austin Calitro.
No doubt, Cherry Calitro will have to do a lot of the heavy lifting on defense. At times tonight, we've seen that front four do a solid job being able to put up at least a wall. A couple of young defensive tackles as Ricky Young is in there now, big old number 99. With Osei and Passigno as the defensive ends. Right now, they're going to that look we saw early in the first quarter with the wide receiver, Danny Ferentz, taking the snap and almost went over his head as Young tried to get him down instead out on the perimeter. It's a nice move by Ferentz to pick up quite a chunk.
Yeah, I think he's going to have a first down. You know, it always seems that, Nick, that kind of broken play, the snap, and he comes back and gets it, and he picks up 11 yards and a first down.
So giving a blow to Torgerson and also giving a bit of a changeup at the Villanova defense.
And you assume Ferentz is going to run. He's a wide receiver, but you assume he's going to run the football. Let's see if Penn has something in the bag of tricks for him throwing the ball.
2nd and 9 from the 48. Play clock down to 5. It's again the snap to Ferentz, makes one move, nice counterplay.
It's going to be holding. Yeah, going to be holding on the offense. So Villanova's going to catch a break here.
A roll came in to make the stop for Villanova, but now the penalty will push back the Quakers. Don O'Malley, the tight end.
You see a lot of that sometimes in those cutback plays where the offensive linemen have to shift their body around to try to get their man around. They extend those arms and grab a hold of the defender's jerseys, and it's exposed easily to the referee to make those calls.
Well, the Wildcats can back them up a bit. I'll say first and 18 from the 49-yard line as Alec Torgerson returns to quarterback as Christian Pearson out on the near side slot as they'll run it up the middle. It's a keeper instead by Torgerson. Nice fake there to Schanauer.
Yeah, Penn just doing a good job of mixing run and pass and option and keeping it and pitching it. Just keeping the Villanova defense off balance the whole night. Pick up about 8 yards there on first down.
They've run 54 plays to only Villanova's 19. Unthinkable. Second and 11. They get back to second and manageable, certainly.
And Penn just milking the clock here as it's down to 8:45 in the third quarter.
We were talking to some of the folks from Penn tonight. They said it's a bit of a new spread look, but they're not going to hurry it up against Villanova tonight.
Good job by the interior of the Villanova line there. Looked like White in the middle of that. Cherry as well. McCann up from the safety position. Brings up third and 10.
Third and long. Penn has been able to convert most of them here tonight. They're 7 of 13 tonight on third down. Third and 10 from the 43. They have time. There's only 15 left on the play clock. It's a newer offense the last couple of seasons. Now it's for John Reagan, formerly the Kansas offensive coordinator. Torgerson will give it to Schanauer. Had an initial hole up the middle. And gets about half of it that they need. And they're controlling the
interesting call here. Now it's fourth and 5 from the 38. If I'm Penn, I'm punting the football here, but it looks like they're going to go for it. I don't see why you want to give Villanova any momentum here unless they're maybe looking to try to draw them offsides before the punt.
Penn is 0 for 1 on fourth down. It was the interception late in the first half. Villanova might be offsides, which would give Penn the first down.
That's exactly what they were looking for, and Villanova fell for the second time tonight.
Exactly on fourth and 5. Exactly what they need to move the chains. Another penalty on the Wildcats, and Penn, no matter how it is, they're somehow converting on every third down.
Yeah, just too many mistakes. You know, Ed Shockley jumping off sides there for the Wildcats. Just too many mistakes. You know, in a game like this now, you're midway through the third quarter, you're down two scores. You cannot afford to keep that team on the field. You got them fourth and 5 or a chance to turn the momentum of the game, and you just jump off sides and give them an automatic first down.
Penn looking for their first win against Villanova in over a century. Now, they didn't play for a lot of those decades through the 20th century, but you can feel it that something might be happening for Penn unless the Wildcats can somehow turn it around. Torgerson gets it wide open to Countryman out on the near side. That's his first catch tonight.
That's another first down for Penn. Pitch and catch, run it. Just really effective offense from the Penn Quakers tonight. Really, Villanova's had no answer for the Penn offense. Nice. Now, they've held them to 14 points, but you know the turnover in the end zone was just been unable to get off the field.
No doubt. You see the good quarterbacks know how to spread it around. Don't try to go to the same guy over and over again. If the Wildcats take Watson away, then he'll go to somebody else. Watson is not on the field, but watch out for Christian Pearson, number 83 on the far side slot, had a big touchdown, 45-yard score last week at Lehigh. On first and 10 for the Quakers, the pitch to Schanauer. Wildcats track him down nicely. Majors and Cherry.
Yeah, good job by Passano to force the tip, and then Majors and Cherry wrap him up for no gain.
So second down coming up for Penn. Calitro already with 12 tackles in the game. Wow. Cherry now has 9. Torgerson looks to the sideline.
Cats are going to need a play here. You're going to need a turnover. The way the offense has been unable to move the football tonight, they're going to need something from the defense.
We'll see if the Wildcats will send more pressure.
I was talking about this game. He went in there and took a bunch of carries, and he was just talking about how he felt like he was only getting about 2 to 3 yards of pop, and it was the hardest, like, 63 yards that he rushed for in his career. But we just continued to fight, continued to let that clock run. We ran the ball a lot more in the second half and tried to protect the ball and, again, keep our defense off of the field. So if they don't have the ball, they can't score.
Third and seven for the Quakers. Third down has been their go-to here tonight. 7 for 14. While the Wildcats are 0 for 4 on third down this evening. They stack the receivers on the near side. Play clock down to 3. Torgerson trying to go with the little receiver screen. Penalty flag down as he got it out in space to Strauss.
That's going
to
be holding on Penn out wide down the kind of the bubble screen look. The interesting decision here for Coach Talley. It's fourth down at the 19-yard line. A field goal opportunity here is 3-score game with 5:16 to go in the third quarter. Do you accept a penalty or make it third and 15, or do you decline it and bring up fourth down?
That's like the blocking holding on the screen play with Florida State and Notre Dame last year late in the game. How quickly do those receivers have to let go when they're blocking on a screen play?
I agree with the choice here by Coach Talley. You have to take them out of field goal range because, you know, at 17-0, 3 scores, the way the Villanova offense has played, could be tough to overcome. But now you're going to ask your defense to make 2 good plays again on defense.
Torgerson has come up with the plays tonight when he's needed to. He's thrown for 156 yards and 2 touchdowns. Third and 17 from the 29-yard line. As Penn will drain more of the clock. But now just over 5 minutes.
Kick at this point of the game.
Jimmy Gamel missed earlier in the game, but he'll get a second opportunity here.
Maybe just about inside 46. The 31, so it'll list it at 40 on the official chart, but just inside of 41 yards here, and obviously a big kick with 4:25 to go in the third quarter.
His career long is 48 for the senior out of Ohio. Fourth down, the kick is up, and it is good.
Wow, so a big kick there from puts the Penn Quakers up 17-0, so it's now a 3-score game.
The Quakers lead the Wildcats 17-0 here late in the third quarter as the Wildcats get somewhat of a stop, and they have time left here in the third quarter to get the football back and to try and start something.
Yeah, so that's 10 points for the Quakers off turnovers today.
No doubt a struggle for Villanova, but the defense still making some stops when they've needed to. They've, I think, played a little bit better than maybe some were giving them credit for. This game could be a lot worse, maybe.
So, yeah, you know, Villanova's kind of held them at bay on the scoreboard, but just in terms of time of possession, the inability to get off the field on third down, to give your offense some field position, they haven't been able to do that today, and the offense has just sputtered and has not done anything at all offensively.
You feel for the offensive linemen, certainly new guys in new spots, players who haven't played before. You're without key veterans. You're without two of your starting tackles who are already out with injury. You're replacing 2 all-conference guys in Ross Hall and Vince Kowalski from last year. It's no doubt a lot different than a year ago. And obviously you're down to star quarterback John Robertson. As Morgan will kick off. And it will not go out of bounds. Takes a bounce there. Good Zach off the hop as the sophomore takes it.
Just interesting how the bounces just aren't going Villanova's way. That ball landed about 3 inches from the sideline, kicked back into the field. Otherwise, Villanova picks up the ball in much better field position if that ball ends up out of bounds.
If you're Penn, you need the bounce of the ball to go your way. They're getting the penalties and a bounce like that, figuratively and literally sometimes.
All right, Nick, as Yogi Berra said, it's getting late early here in the third quarter, so God rest in peace there, Yogi Berra. I'm a big Yankee fan, great Yankee, 10 World Series championships, but the Wildcat offense needs to get going here.
They need a little bit of luck indeed. Can they get it going?
So we see John Robertson on the sideline there.
First and 10 for Zach Bednarczyk and Villanova. Bednarczyk, deep drop here over the middle, easy throw. It's complete to Taurus Phillips. And they move the chains.
Yeah, that crossing pattern has been good to Villanova over the years. O-line provides Bednarczyk with some time, and he's able to hit a Taurus Phillips on the crossing pattern for a big first down. The Wildcats look to pick up the pace here.
Nice, simple, easy throw to get them in a rhythm and give them some confidence. Wells will line up on that far side. Javon White in the backfield for Villanova on first and 10 from the 44. They give the handoff to Javon White. Has space on the perimeter. Dodges one tackle. There goes White down the sideline. And another first down for Nova.
A couple of positive plays from the Villanova offense. One in the passing game, one in the running game, as Javon White's able to streak down the right side. Put the ball at first and 10 inside the 40, about at the 35-yard line.
A nice adjustment suddenly by the Wildcats. Starting to block better up at the point of attack, no doubt about it. It'll be first and 10. Javon White with a big run, 21 yards. This time they'll give it to White again. Penalty flag.
A late flag there. I'm not sure what, if that's holding or it looks like one of the Wildcats is down on the field as well.
One of the Wildcats is down. Obviously, with lots of injuries so far to start this season, whether it's been Robertson, McCann. Second sideline interference call of the game for Villanova, Steve. Five-yard penalty. You said you've never seen this.
Nick, I had never seen one. I've seen two in one game. This is the kind of night it's been here at Villanova Stadium.
Obviously, lots of injuries.
Trying to get it. Unfortunately, we can't get a look at that number to identify who the injured Wildcat is at this time.
See notable Wildcats on that sideline. Robertson, Brad Seaton, multiple injuries. A chance to get a lot of these guys back later in the season, but at least right now, these are the guys that are on the field. And both teams will go to their respective sidelines. And it looks like it's the tight end in Ryan Morris, the Purdue transfer. They'll have to help him off the sideline. Now it's time to step up for Ryan Bell. Doug Terrell's already playing tackle.
Exactly. Doug Terrell has been moved to tackle, so Wildcats are actually back to their third tight end now.
So Bell will take the field here.
So now you're also down three offensive linemen and a tight end.
He graduated Petway from last year. It's a different-looking team just a year later. Gullius might have man coverage on the near side on second and 12. Underwood is in the backfield. Bell on the wing left. Zach will throw. Gets a complete. No, it's dropped by Gullius.
No, it's just kind of like we saw with Aaron Wells in the first half, trying to run before they catch the ball. Got to look it in, secure the ball, and then head upfield. Gullius had a step going upfield before he secured the pass.
Normally, he brings that ball in so well. Ninth in the Colonial in receptions to start this year.
Brings up third and 12. And I think you're almost looking at four down territory here. Down three scores with 2:56 to go in the third quarter.
Third and 12 for the Wildcats. They are 0-for-4 on third down. Four wide receivers. They get the call from the sideline. As Bednarczyk will throw. Deep drop. Good time. Safety valve and Underwood underneath. Nice move by Gary. Spin move in the open field. He's got the first down and then some as the pile will carry the Wildcats into the red zone.
So the Wildcats' first third down conversion today is obviously a big one. Is Bednarczyk went back, looked through all his reads and all his options, and then he had the checkoff. And Gary Underwood made a nice spin move to pick up some yak after the catch.
So important there to finally get into the red zone and give yourself some momentum. The Wildcats are 7-for-11 this year in the red zone. First and 10, little jet sweep there to McClinton as the rookie dashes to the 5-yard line.
Yeah, the freshman right out of high school gets it down at about the 11, so he'll pick up about 5 yards on first down.
Nice job for McClinton, so quick, he has such potential and we see it there. Padovani will check in as a wide receiver. Gullius will be on the near side. Goodzak will check in for Underwood. Bednarczyk in the gun. Checking the play from the sideline. 10 left on the play clock on 2nd and 6 from the 11. It's the handoff. Nope, the fake. Bednarczyk on the keeper will run with it. Bednarczyk gets knocked out of bounds right by the 1 yard line.
Yeah, it's going to be first and goal inside the 5 yard line. Probably about the 1, as you mentioned, Nick. So it's going to be first and goal at the 1 for the Wildcats.
Finally, momentum for the Wildcats. Bednarczyk last weekend had that one run, but it was a big one. A 21 yard scamper for that go ahead touchdown and the comeback win against Delaware. He's looked poised when he's had time tonight.
Let's see if the Wildcat can punch this in here and get some momentum going.
First and goal at the 1 yard line. They'll go shotgun with Bednarczyk. They'll hand it off to Underwood. Gary!
He's in.
He is in for the touchdown.
The ball came out after he had crossed the goal line, so the Wildcats get on the scoreboard with 1:28 to go in the third quarter. It's Penn 17. Villanova 6 with the point after to come.
Second rushing touchdown of the year. Of course, Underwood had the great game against Penn last year when he had a couple of touchdowns and that career-high 93 yards on the ground. As we'll see, the extra point by Gerard Smith, the freshman out of Garden City, New York, instead of Steve Weiler. Bednarczyk will do the holding. The kick is up. It is good. With 1:28 left in the third quarter, it's Penn 17 and Villanova 7. Exactly what the doctor ordered there, Steve.
Yeah, I was hoping that you got to try to get one in the end zone before the end of the third quarter. Now it's a two-possession game. You got a full quarter to play. Now your defense really needs to step up and get a three and out and get that ball right back to the offense.
270 total yards of offense for Penn. The Wildcats, 106. 1 yard rushing touchdown by Underwood, the fifth rushing touchdown of his career. And a nice job to really be physical there at the one to kind of bull himself in. Now the defense pumping themselves up here to try and make a play to really turn this game around to get Penn's offense off the field.
Yeah, you know, obviously a turnover would be huge. Get a short field for your offense.
Obviously, still a ball game here late in the third quarter. Scoring drive was 8 plays, 74 yards, only took 241.
Yeah, that's the big thing. Yeah, the quick strike is what you need. You know, Villanova's offense has that capability. It doesn't need 6-7 minutes to strike. And I think tonight especially, they're going to need some big plays because it's not a group that's going to be out there for 12, 14 play drives with all the inexperience on the offensive line, the inexperienced quarterback.
Yeah, a little bit different last week when a quarterback that hasn't played before. Here's the kickoff by Weiler. Sometimes you play off adrenaline. A little bit different in your first career start for Bednarczyk. Certainly, backup lineman, a lot to do with it as the return comes up to around the 20-yard line by Fiore. Yeah,
good coverage by the kick team there from Villanova. Looks like McCann on the tackle. Or McCurry, excuse me.
He's an absolute warrior for the Wildcats. Cam McCurry comes up with a little limp there. We hope he's okay. Penn will have it first and 10 from the 19-yard line. Wildcats trailing by 10.
Let's see if the Wildcats defense can step up here.
It'll be Alec Torgerson in the shotgun with Brian Schanauer to his right. Schanauer has run for 37 yards. Trey Solomon has run for 51 yards. Torgerson only 10 yards. That's because of sacks added in. There's the room for Solomon, who breaks the tackle and gets a first down.
Yeah, good job by Solomon to get through the gap there. Villanova still missing tackles. So first and 10 for the Quakers. The thing is, you just want the time of possession has just been so lopsided. Villanova needs to get off the field and get off the field quickly.
32 minutes for Penn, 10 and a half minutes for Villanova tonight. First and 10 for the Quakers. Looking for their first win of the season, looking for their first win in over 100 years against Villanova. Their last Thursday night game was against Villanova here at Villanova Stadium in 2002, a 17-3 Villanova win. Nice stop at the point of attack there for Eric Drains, and the linebackers clean it up.
Good job, Reggie Parrison on that as well.
Passanio
So the Quakers will be forced to run one more play before the end of the third quarter.
25 seconds left. We'll say second and 9 from the 33-yard line. Jason Senius comes in for coverage for the Wildcats. Wes Smith playing deep as a safety. Torgerson will hand it off. Nice burst by Schanauer, and that will end the third quarter.
Going to bring up an all-important third down for the Quakers. It'll be third down at about 4 from their own 38-yard line.
When we come back, it's Penn on top.
I'm Justin Watson, wide receiver from the 2015 Penn football team. Thanks for watching our upset against Villanova, and please support Penn football. Go Quakers.
Great to have you with us. Not exactly what we thought might occur tonight,
yeah,
Steve.
But the Wildcats have one quarter to make amends here. It's third down and 4 from the 38 for the Quakers.
Third downs tonight for Penn, 7 of 15. The Wildcats finally converted a third down on their last drive when they finally got on the scoreboard. They need a big stop here. There's no doubt about it. What a way to start the fourth quarter it might be. It's Torgerson. He gets hit as he throws, and it is complete to Adam Strauss.
What a play by Torgerson. He took a shot from Passanyaw as he released that ball, but the slant has been open all day, and Penn has been a great job of completing that pass.
The tough quarterbacks hang in the pocket, make that throw under duress, and Torgerson.
Yeah, and now that obviously allows Penn to eat up 3 or 4 more minutes on offense here with the first down.
Nice job to get rid of the football when you're under pressure. The smart quarterbacks know how to make the plays when they need to. That clock goes off, and Torgerson certainly has that. First and 10 from the 44. He'll throw again, looking for a little wide receiver screen. Once again to Strauss.
Yeah, it's just been real effective on first down all night. It's picking up big bunches and chunks of yards. They get 9 right here on first down again.
A big key we just talked about right during our timeout. Justin Watson hasn't played in this second half.
They've been able to find a couple other people to go to. That big third down there, they found Strauss. He came up with the first down.
Watson might be a little bit banged up. We don't want to speculate too much. He is on the sideline without his helmet on. Appears to have the bottom part of his leg wrapped.
And Penn here milking the clock as they bring the play clock down under 10 seconds.
Second and 1. A nice chunk there. As Strauss, a part of it. It's Torgerson. Cherry missed him. And then eventually it's Reggie Paris.
After, you know, Torgerson gets enough, as you mentioned, Cherry unable to bring him down behind the line of scrimmage. He'll pick up a first down for Penn as they move into Wildcat territory at the 43-yard line.
The similarities are there for Robertson and Torgerson. There's no doubt we've seen John escape many tackles.
And the mix of pass and run that he's been able to show and spreading the ball around, as you mentioned earlier, Nick, to different receivers has kept Villanova's defense off balance.
13-24 remaining. First and 10 for the Quakers from the 43. They'll stack double tight end here. Looking for a little power football as they give it up the middle. Nice burst up the gut for Schanauer.
Another effective first down for the Quakers. They pick up 5 yards to bring up short a second and 5. And they've been living it third down and 3, third down and 4 all game. Makes it tough on the Villanova defense.
Nice job by their guards tonight. Daniel Pulos, the left guard. Dan Lysenko, the right guard, a senior. Has 12 starts underneath his belt. It's a developing but solid offensive line for the Quakers. Second and 5 as Schanauer has been pretty solid. He's run for 61 yards on the ground tonight. It's Torgerson this time. Not much. Nice coverage there by C.J. Logan.
So it's going to bring up third down and about 3, but you might be looking at 4-down territory again. As Penn was willing to go for it back in the third quarter on their own 40. They're inside the 40 now, so I would assume this is 2-down territory for the Quakers.
Ricky Young came off as the nose guard. Eric Drains checks in the middle of that defensive line for Villanova. Third and 2 for the Quakers. They'll bring the play clock under 10. They shift Schanauer to the right of Torgerson, who's in the shotgun. They hand it off to Schanauer, and he gets
He's going to be short, probably about a, I don't think he's going to get anything. He's going to be 2 yards short. He's going to bring up 4th down and 2 from the 35. So big decision here for Ray Piori, the head coach of the Quakers. And it looks like they're going to go for it. I don't see anyone coming in off the sideline, so Here's a big play in this ball game at 11:30 to go. Fourth down for the Penn Quakers and 2 yards to go.
It doesn't seem like they want to hand it over to Villanova's offense, so they are going for it.
And this is where Villanova twice has jumped off sides to give them first down. So the Wildcats got to be disciplined here.
0 for 1 officially tonight on fourth down. It was the interception in the end zone late in the second quarter by Malik Reeves. And now a timeout possibly will be called by Penn. Will they rethink this?
They might. They may have just said, hey, we'll try to draw them off sides. If we can't get them off sides, we'll go punt the football. But I don't see anyone coming in from the Penn sideline. Looks like they're deciding to go for this.
They're staying very aggressive. As Ray Priori, no doubt, has done a great job with his group tonight. We have a new offense, defense, a new coordinator as well. Wildcats tonight getting the offense going here late in the ball game. But they barely had the ball, only 10 minutes plus here this evening.
Yeah, Nick, not a gamble here. It's really probably a 15-yard difference. You punt the ball in the end zone, you give Villanova the ball at the 20. If Villanova can get a stop here, they'll take the ball at the 35. But it just gives you that momentum. That fourth down stop gives your team some momentum. So it's interesting to see what happens here.
133 yards on the ground tonight for Penn as a team rushing. They've been solid in two. It'll be a pistol look with Schanauer behind Torgerson. Play clock at 17, so they have plenty of time.
See if Villanova's defensive line can get some penetration here.
Torgerson will back up, and he will do a quick kick. And he gets it away. The ball will bounce all the way downfield, and it will be downed within the 10.
Interesting call there by the Quakers. So they do pick up about 27 yards on the punt. So Villanova now picks up the ball first and 10 from their own 8-yard line, but a stop from the Villanova defense.
Randall Cunningham used to punt for the Eagles back day. He could really kick the football. So Priori deciding to back up the Wildcats.
So let's see if the Wildcats can put a 92-yard drive together here to get this thing to 17-14.
The ball will be at the 8-yard line, first and 10. Zach Bednarczyk, he's thrown for 63 yards tonight. It's the rookie McClinton, able to shake a tackle. Gets about 8 or 9.
Yeah, he did a good finish that run strong. He got himself out almost to the 18-19-yard line. It's going to bring up second down and short. Villanova with a little bit of sense of urgency here as there's 10:42 to go in the fourth quarter.
They do substitute on offense. Nice job in the middle of that defense tonight by Connaughton, the defensive tackle. It'll be second and 1, a gain of 9 on that last play. It's Javon White to the right side, and he gets the first down.
Yeah, good job by Javon White. Get his shoulders upfield. Get the ball past the 20 for the first down.
Nice job by Kevin Ijoma. Wildcats get just their 7th first down of the evening to the 22 that Penn has tonight. First and 10 for Villanova. They're at the 21-yard line. Do they have to throw the ball a whole lot while they play catch-up? Bednarczyk, hit as he throws, gets it complete to Underwood, and eventually wrapped up.
He's going to be first down marker. It'll be interesting to see. Looks like they're signaling second down.
Both quarterbacks know how to hang tough.
Actually,
in that
they're going to. I think they're going to measure. Now they're going to call first down.
Well, the Wildcats get the break there. Move the chains. Clock stops. And now eventually get going here, 9:46 and counting. It's McClinton taking it on the jet sweep. Makes one move. Nice job by McClinton. Gets about 5.
Yeah, the Wildcats finding something they like there and running wide against the Quakers. Had tough. We talked about the defensive tackles playing very well up the middle. Villanova trying to spread them to the outside a little bit. And then you wouldn't be surprised if you see him maybe with that little play action and then go maybe deep to Aaron Wells over the middle.
Is that big play out there for Villanova? It's second and 4. Shotgun Bednarczyk, Underwood in the backfield. Penn show up at the line. Watch out for Drake. Now they push a safety up closer as well. 9 left on the play clock. Slate bobble by Bednarczyk. Gets it out to Padovani. Nice job to run with the football into Penn territory and a first down.
Good job. I mean, getting the ball out quick. Finds Padovani on just a little out route. And the Wildcats are into Quaker territory at the 49-yard line.
The Wildcats will have the ball in Penn territory with 8:51 left.
The clock keeps moving, unfortunately, as we're down, as Nick mentioned, under 8:45 left.
Big field goal by Hamill in that third quarter. It's the sweep here to Aaron Wells, who gets about five.
Villanova needs to get up over the ball here as they're two possessions down.
Maybe not as quick compared to when John Robertson's in there. Maybe might have something with your offensive line, some new guys in different places tonight.
But if you could score with, say, more than 6 minutes to go, you have your three timeouts, you might be able to get two possessions of offense.
Second and five for Bednarczyk and the Wildcats. Underwood shifts to his left. Get it over the middle, and it looks to be complete to Taurus Phillips.
Taurus Phillips for another first down. So Wildcats getting some momentum here as they're moving the ball down the field. And you need two scores, so even a field goal here doesn't hurt you. Gets you right back in the game in a one-score game.
Because they're still moving rather quickly. First and 10 for the Wildcats. It'll be Bednarczyk. Good time. Nice throw to Aaron Wells. Gets it down to the 20-yard line. First down, Wildcats, and they are moving.
Got the ball up first inside the 20 at the 19, so good throws. The offensive line has held up well during this drive.
Starting to play with more confidence. Starting to get a drive, a couple of drives going, where they have time. Work against the Penn defense. Bednarczyk in the shotgun. Look at the sideline. Gullius and Aaron Wells on the near side. Low snap, Bednarczyk, no problem. Throws over the middle, too high for Phillips. You need to get a score here, no matter what it is, to get within one score. Underwood out, Javon White checks in on second and 10 from the 19. Bednarczyk has now thrown for 112 yards. The Wildcats have run for 67 yards. Trying to add more. Nice room there. Javon White gets to the perimeter.
That's another first down. Yeah, it's going to be first and goal from about the 8-yard line. Good job on the offensive line as they pulled both the guard around. And Javon White had a huge hole to run through.
Nice job by Green and D'Angelo and Terrell. Everybody up there starting to get the job done. Wildcats snapping it rather quickly. Ball comes out. They will say fumble on Villanova, and the Quakers have it. They are running it downfield. A huge game changer as Donald Panciello will take it all the way to the house for the Penn touchdown. And Penn extends their lead.
What a heartbreaking play as Villanova had the ball inside the 5-yard line, and unfortunately, Javon White coughed it up, and Penn picks it up, runs 95 yards. For a back-breaking touchdown.
I was able to maintain outside leverage and I was able to get the ball out.
Because it's kind of like unreal. It's slow motion. You don't really know what's going on the other sideline, where you just hear people scream fumble.
Took a crazy bounce and actually ended up not touching any white and stayed in. So I scooped it. I peeked to my left and had a group of guys. I think Mad Dog was leading the way. And yeah, just started going towards the 50, and for some reason it just seemed like there were no blue around, just all white. So we kind of coasted in thereafter, and it was like Drake said, long drive. So I was huffing and puffing by the time we got to the other end zone, but it was great.
We all were.
Just admit your first thought was like, don't get caught.
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, I just had at that point, I just had to hold on to the ball, to secure possession. Definitely wasn't thinking touchdown off the bat. Definitely wanted just secure possession and try to make a couple of people miss and break a couple of tackles. I was going to try to do that. But thankfully, didn't have to do that. It was a clear path to the end zone from like the 5-yard line.
Panciello all the way downfield and makes it a bigger lead for the Quakers. And they are in control of this game. Obviously, no replay challenge system available. So the call will stand, and Villanova in danger of dropping this one. There's still time left. Extra point is good.
Yeah, the high snap. Good job by the holder to get it down.
Jimmy Gamble, nice job by the holder, and Christian Stapleton to get it down. with 6:51 left when you're close to the goal line and the other team's able to scoop and score. And that pretty much is a backbreaker if you're Villanova.
And looking at that, you know, that high snap on the extra points, obviously a big play because now it's a three-score game instead of a potential Villanova to score two touchdowns and two-point conversions to tie. So Villanova will now need three scores and only 6:51.
Not a whole lot of time left to do so. A little bit different when you're trailing by just seven or down by just a couple, as has been the case against Delaware in recent memory. They had a great comeback against Delaware at PPL Park 2 years ago, but you had a whole fourth quarter to get that done. Now, not that much time left. You had Robertson on the field that day. Here's another short kick, as Goodzak has to let it bounce. Another one that bounces in. Goodzak breaks a couple of tackles, and a penalty flag is thrown.
Yeah, that's going to push Villanova back inside their own 10, I believe.
The Wildcats in that game against Delaware had over 600 yards of total offense that day. And
this one's going to be on Ed Shockley.
Oh, it'll come. So yeah. Half the distance. Yeah.
Just too many mistakes today, Nick. Obviously the turnover late, but just too many mistakes in the kicking game, the personal foul on the punt. Just not handling the kickoff early in the first half. So teams has really struggled today. And then there's just the back-breaking fumble there late in the mid-fourth quarter to make this a three-score game.
Well, the Wildcats will have to go the length of the field. Three timeouts left. Bednarczyk starting the shotgun on first and 10. The ball is at the 7-yard line. He's looking to throw. Out in space to McClinton, and Penn wraps up and drives him. Forward motion will give him the ball at the 5-yard line.
Yeah, so that'll be a loss of about 2 yards to bring up second down and 12.
Nice job of tackling space there by Madden and those great linebackers. Moskal has had a good night. Drake, nice veteran. Calitro has 13 tackles tonight. Don Cherry has 11. Moskal has 7 tackles. Austin Tapp, 5. That defensive line has done a real nice job for the Quakers. Second and 12, ball at the 5-yard line. Under 6 minutes to play in the game. They barely get the playoff. Bednarczyk will throw out there. Nice job to Taurus Phillips. It's complete, and they get some of it back. It'll be third down.
Yeah, third down and about 6. Wildcats, obviously, even at this deep in their own territory, I believe have to go for it on fourth down, being down by 3 scores.
They basically need a series of big plays if they're to get back into it. Saying third and 5 for the Wildcats, who are just 1 of 5 on third down tonight. There's still time left. Bednarczyk will dump short. And it's caught, first down. Wildcats move the chains. Underwood.
But as you mentioned, Nick, the time dwindling down here, 5:27 to go. We're going to need some big plays in the passing game to score quickly. Then obviously the onside kick will have to come into play at some point.
Third catch tonight for Underwood. McClinton lines up on the near side. 5:12 remaining. Bednarczyk looking to throw. Over the middle, it's bobbled and incomplete by Padovani.
Yeah.
Had his hands on it, yeah, initially.
Yeah, probably got to pull that one down. He had both hands on the ball. It was a little bit high, but a pretty good throw from Bednarczyk, and Padovani unable to haul it in.
McClinton, Gullius, DiCamillo, and Phillips will all be out there on second and 10. Gullius will be on the far side. McClinton will line up on that far side slot as well. Aaron Wells on the near side slot. Penn expect Villanova to throw the football, so they know what's coming. Second and 10. Penn will rush 4. Bednarczyk will step up. He'll run with it. Tries to slide. Gets down. Gets about 8.
Yeah, so it'll be third down and about 2 here as the clock ticks under 5 minutes.
We're still seeing pretty good intangibles by Bednarczyk tonight. He's hung in the pocket tough. He's made some very good throws. Not all of them have been caught. At times there hasn't been protection. We've seen some drops tonight. Third and two for the Wildcats. 4:34 left in the ballgame. Bednarczyk will scramble. Has to throw back to Gullius. It's incomplete. Tough throw there. It'll be fourth down.
Yeah, Penn did a good job of forcing him out of the pocket from the Wildcats' 28-yard line.
He rolled left last week when he entered the game. Still got that good throw off. So he can do that, but it's not an easy throw for a southpaw. Fourth and two, Steve. And this might be your ball game if Villanova has any life left. Ball's on the 28-yard line. We'll see if Bednarczyk has a play to continue for Villanova. It's complete, and I think they have the first down. As he gets it to, looks like DiCamillo.
Yep, so that moves the chains, and Wildcats keep their slim hopes alive here with 4:20 to go.
Could they get McClinton out in space on a big gainer? Ian Dobbins playing as that single high deep safety. First and 10 at the 33. Bednarczyk will step up, he'll run it himself. Linebackers ready for him there in Panciello.
And Penn will take that all day. You know, a 5-yard run, that eats up 30, 40 seconds of clock. Cats are going to have to take a couple of shots downfield here to try to get something quick.
We'll say second and four. 3:39 left. Here's Bednarczyk once again, looking to step up in the pocket, run with it, find some running room, and gets just a couple.
That'll be third and short, probably about a 1/2 yard.
Receivers are head field, but the coverage is there, and Coach Talley will use his first timeout.
You got to give Penn credit when the Penns made the plays when they needed to. Their defense was able to hold up there in the fourth quarter when it looked like Villanova was going to get right back in the game at 17-14. They force a fumble. And I thought they've just done a great job. You got to give Torgerson credit. He's thrown it. He's running. He's spread the ball around. He's been really efficient. Really, he had the interception in the end zone. That's always, you know, really his receiver's fault. Just kind of gave up on that ball. So you got to give Penn credit. They played very well tonight.
Third and one for the Wildcats as Bednarczyk has thrown for 130. He's run for 20 yards. He's under a rush. Steps up in the pocket again, and he cannot get it.
I think it's a first down, actually. I think he gave him forward progress. It is going to be a first down. He made it by about a 1/2 yard.
So he just gets it. Clock will stop with 3:14 left and two timeouts for Villanova to give you at least some sort of life left, but it's going to be very tough. 3:02. Bednarczyk from the 44-yard line. Torgerson has thrown for 171 tonight and two touchdowns. That's incomplete.
It looked like it could have been pass interference, but it, like I said, only a 3-yard out pattern. Wildcats need bigger chunks than that at this stage.
Matt Henderson, the junior linebacker, Bloomington, Indiana. Makes a nice play on the ball. Penn using some backups there on the defensive line. Eric Swanson, the nose guard, gets some time in relief of Connaughton. The Wildcat line has played much better as the game has gone along. Second and 10 with 2:52 left. Ball's at the 44-yard line. Bednarczyk will throw back. Difficult throw. Gets it complete to Gullius. Trying to get out of bounds. Breaks a tackle. He cuts infield. That'll move the chains and stop the clock. Clock stops with 2:41 left. It'll be first down for the Wildcats.
Content to just kind of, you know, make Villanova use time, knowing they need three scores here.
First and 10 for the Wildcats, ball 36. It's complete. First down again for Villanova. They move the chains as Bednarczyk hooks up with, it looks like, DiCamillo. Yet again.
And Wildcats move into the red zone here at the 21-yard line. Let's see if they can take a couple quick shots at the end zone. With the clock running here, I'm not sure why it was running with the first chains were not set.
They should have stopped the clock there. Should have been 2:20. Instead, now down to 2:12. So you lose a little bit of time. Bednarczyk getting set here. Dump off to Underwood. And he's trying to get the first down to at least move the chains.
Maybe another timeout here from Villanova. But the clock is running now under 2 minutes.
They have two timeouts left. The clock.
And I'm not sure why the clock stopped there. No one called timeout, and it was not a first down for Gary Underwood.
He got 8 yards. Maybe it's a makeup call. Obviously, they didn't get it right there. Bednarczyk will throw on second and two. Has time. They're playing coverage. He runs with it here, and he gets out of bounds at least. That'll get the first down by...
Looks like they're going to mark him a little bit short.
Oh, he's short.
It's going to be third and one, I believe.
Clock stops with 1:44.
Third down and one for the Wildcats.
At least try and get into the end zone here and finish off as strongly as you can. Lincoln Collins will check in on the far side with Aaron Wells. Underwood in the backfield. Down and one for Villanova. Just 3 of 8 tonight on third down. Bednarczyk gets it to Underwood. And tackled by Ijoma with help from Panciello.
So it'll be first and goal for the Wildcats at about the 8-yard line with 1:37 to go.
And the Wildcats will call a timeout. That's their second. They have one remaining.
I think you got to take what they were Penn, giving Penn you. Was playing two deep safeties. You know, they're going to give up that chunk. So Bednarczyk just had to take what they gave him, and that was those little chunks. And Penn was fine with that because it's going to eat up, you know, most of the game. Villanova needed 3 scores. They're very happy to, you know, if Villanova ends up punching one in here, having them use up 4 or 5 minutes on the clock.
Hats off to the offensive line for Villanova. So many new players for Villanova in new spots. So they'll save goal from the 8. Underwood in the backfield, 4 wide receivers. Golius on the near side for Bednarczyk. Pretty good protection. Then Proust couldn't hold his man. Bednarczyk throws into the end zone. It was tipped. He had Wells open, and it's broken up.
Yeah, good job. But it looks like the linebacker dropping deep into the end zone to get his hands up.
That's
can't
Panciello
make a number. Was
again?
That Panciello again? I couldn't.
Oh,
yeah.
Man, what a
he's
game.
He's had a heck of a game in that middle linebacker position. Got his hands on that ball to knock it down.
So second down, Nick Miller, one of their young linebackers, had a tip ball earlier in the game. Drake, Moskal, Yellow, Madden, they've all had great games. Solid linebackers for Coach Priori. It'll be second and 8, but Bednarczyk throws, he's got it, touchdown, McClinton. So, with 1:23 left.
You know, it may be too little too late, but a pretty good drive by the Villanova offense there. Unfortunately, just ate up too much time to give them any chance to make a comeback.
The first career touchdown for Jarrett McClinton. And it looks like they will kick the extra point. And that will get them within 10 with 1:14 left. The extra point will be taken by Gerard Smith, and the snap is no good. The Wildcats have to just go sit on it before Penn picks it up. They could return this for 2. And they can't advance it. So the problems continue for Villanova with 1:26 left. It's Penn 24 and Villanova 13.
So obviously Nick Villanova here will go with the onside kick to try to get possession back, showing by 11 points with only a minute and 26 seconds left in the game.
That field goal by Gamble turned out to be huge in that third quarter.
Yeah.
Even with that touchdown return by Panciello, the Wildcats, whom you make that extra point, you're within at least a little bit closer.
Yeah, you know, it would be 21-14 here within 1 score, and then anything can happen with an onside kick. Yeah, huge field goal. But I think the momentum all just went out of the place when that the fumble by Javon White inside the 5-yard line.
McClinton tonight, 3 catches, 15 yards. Bednarczyk has thrown for 185. These are obviously new career highs for players that haven't played before a whole lot, so a new career high for Bednarczyk, obviously, in his first career start. So the onside kick will be attempted by Weiler. Takes a decent bounce, but it's gobbled up by the Quakers as they get Adam Strauss to grab it.
So the Wildcats with only 1 timeout left, Penn can pretty much milk this away if they want to take a knee on three plays here. That should just about do it.
1:25 left. One timeout left for the Wildcats. And they'll have some extra time to get ready for William & Mary.
Yeah, and hopefully
it doesn't get any easier.
Yeah, no, it does. William & Mary, really good club this year. It's going to be a tough game back here at Villanova Stadium. Hopefully Villanova can get some of those offensive linemen back, get some healthy players, and try to build and come back from this tough loss.
It looks like the Wildcats moved first on that onside kick. So a procedure call, and that will give Penn an extra 5 yards. The big one on Saturday, Stony Brook and William & Mary. That should be one of the better games in the CAA. Stony Brook took down New Hampshire last weekend. They will take a knee. The Wildcats can use their last timeout.
And they do. So that takes it down to 1:22.
Not a lot of time left. And Penn, it's looking good for them right now. Stony Brook will be at William & Mary this Saturday night in what should be the game of the week in the Colonial. The Wildcats have always had trouble with the Tribe, but they've come back and beat them a couple times in recent memory.
Yeah, and it's always been a good rivalry, very good. Two strong clubs in the CAA over the years. Jimmy Laycock, Andy Talley, two of the longest tenured coaches in the CAA. Should be an interesting battle, and look for the Wildcats to rebound, I think, both offensively and defensively.
Cluey has done pretty well, the quarterback for the Tribe. No more Trey McBride. He's moved on. Richmond, they've graduated some players, but they have great receivers back. They'll be a tough out. That'll be our next broadcast against Richmond on November the 14th. Steve and I will see you then. The Wildcats will get ready for William & Mary. They'll get over a week to prepare. Try and get a little bit healthier. With 1 minute left in the ball game, Penn can take
just about.
It's
going to take one more knee to end this. Because if they run this down right to about 40, so if they just take a half a second or two off the clock before they take the knee, they should be able to run it out on this snap.
Third and 10 officially. He'll take a knee. That'll make it fourth down.
And that should just about do it.
That will do it, it looks like. And I think that's it. It is. Penn has done the unthinkable. The upset here on Thursday night on the main line. Villanova, for the first time since 1911. The Wildcats were down some bodies tonight. Penn played a wonderful ball game. Hats off to the Quakers. Torgerson was outstanding. Their defense certainly tackled well. They got the ball in space to their playmakers. Their defense wrapped up and just 2 seconds left, and the ball game is over. Final score, Penn 24, Villanova 13. The Wildcats fall to 2-2. Penn gets their first win of the season. They're 1-1. Their first win in over a century against the Wildcats, Steve.
Yeah, just you got to give Penn credit on all three phases, and an offensive, defense, certainly on special teams. So hats off to the Quakers. Cats have 16 days to rebound and get ready for William & Mary.
Bednarczyk threw for 185 tonight in his first career start without star quarterback John Robertson. Torgerson threw for 171 yards, touchdowns. Penn ran for 140 yards. The Wildcats ran for 96 yards. Underwood had 5 catches to lead the Wildcats. Justin Watson didn't play that second half, but had 5 catches, 87 yards for 2 touchdowns, and Penn able to win it. Final thoughts, Steve?
Yeah, I think, as we mentioned earlier, you got to tip your hat to Penn. I think they came in. Villanova was undermanned, as we talked about earlier in the game, but just did it in all three phases. Won the special teams battle. Villanova was just some early miscues. Mentally just weren't there. Drop passes, the kickoff, just too many mistakes for Villanova. They've got to get back to practice, kind of clean this stuff up a little bit, and be ready to go against William & Mary.
Turns on this team. You know you'll get healthier. You have a great coaching staff. This team will indeed rebound. We are certainly confident of that. These rivalries are always very tricky. Penn came so close for so many years. They finally get it done.